This is a production of SDPB.
Touchdown! This is for a state championship. Oh, direct kick and it's good!
There's going to be some highlights coming off of this.
The short range jumper.
Edging out in lane four, the top seed.
This South Dakota High School State Championship event is conducted under the direction of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
And good afternoon and welcome back to the Summit Arena inside the monument here in Rapid City, South Dakota. I'm Stacey Jones with SDPB, and we have got another great day of basketball coming up for you with the boys. Class A tournament. It's going to be a whole lot of fun. I'm going to send it over to Craig Maddock and Nate Kading with a preview of what's to come today here on SDPB.
Thanks, Stacey. Appreciate it. It's the consolation round here this afternoon. And then later tonight, we get into third place and the championship, which we're expecting to be a good one. But here we are with the seventh place game featuring, you know, Groton Area and Vermillion. So what's the attitude of these teams here this afternoon in the consolation round?
Yeah, certainly it's not what they where they aspire to be when they're starting off this tournament. But all eight teams that we've watched so far over the last 2 days are proud programs, proud teams, and so they want to leave their best foot out whenever they get the opportunity. So you get two groups here today that have a chance to end their season victorious. So we expect them. It might take them a sec to kind of get into things, especially in these early afternoon games, but expect it to be a competitive, hard-fought ball game.
Here's the consolation side of the bracket. Vermillion losing to Sioux Falls Christian on Thursday, and yesterday they lose to Pine Ridge. Meanwhile, Groton Area had a close game with Hamlin. Then Sioux Valley took them out yesterday. So it's Vermillion and Groton Area going at it here for our first game, and then the consolation championship with Pine Ridge and Sioux Valley. Tonight, starting at 7 Central, 6 Mountain, we will have the third place game with Dakota Valley and Rapid City Christian. And the championship, the top two seeds, unbeaten Sioux Falls Christian. And Hamlin will go at it tonight. Let's take a look at Groton Area. Groton Area making their 10th appearance. Groton Area, during the season or during the tournament, they have played five of the teams here in the state tournament. They have lost to Hamlin and Pine Ridge and Dakota Valley and Vermillion, but they've also beaten Dakota Valley during the regular season. Starting lineups for Groton Area. Tracy Keegan had a big day yesterday. He had 17. Ryder Johnson had 19 to lead the way. And the head coach is Brian Dolan.
Yeah, and look for them to really, Lane Teet's kind of their main guy, averaging 21 a night coming into this tournament. The two previous games that they played, they've keyed on them, held them to 12 and 11 points. So I look for him to be very aggressive here this afternoon.
And they take on the Vermillion Tanagers, the 8 seed, making their 14th appearance to the state basketball tournament, the first time since 2021. Before that, you got to go back to the late 80s before Vermillion was here at the boys basketball tournament. Here at the tournament, you see they lost to the top seed Chargers and then lost to Pine Ridge yesterday. Pine Ridge played real well yesterday. Starters for Vermillion. Bryson Skogsberg had a good tournament. You know, he had 15 against Sioux Falls Christian, but had 13 yesterday. And Trey Hansen, 20 points yesterday.
Yeah, really for them defensively, they've struggled, giving up 46% from the floor yesterday against Pine Ridge and giving up 50% from the floor against Sioux Falls Christian. If they're going to have success here with us this afternoon, they're going to really need to focus and lock in on that side of the floor.
And there's the head coach, Jay Drake, in his 16th year. Follow SDPB Sports on your mobile device. Check us out on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. Check out all of the action and award photos. You can search SDPB on Flickr. We love it when you tell us where you're watching us from. And you can read some of the great stories, watch the videos which feature our teams, kids, and coaches at SDPB.com. SDPB.org. Let's meet the starters. Here's Scott Jensen.
Good afternoon, Summit Arena fans at the Monument in Rapid City and everyone watching all over the world on SDPB. Welcome to Championship Saturday of the 2024 South Dakota State A Boys Basketball Tournament. The South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, Dakota Bank, Farmers Union Insurance, Billion Automotive, Agtagra Cooperative, ABC Rentals, The Furniture Mart, South Dakota Highway Patrol, Lake Area Tech, Masaba, Experience Sioux Falls, and the South Dakota Army National Guard are proud to welcome you to this final session of the State A Boys High School Basketball Tournament. Playing for 7th and 8th place this afternoon, the Groton Area Tigers. And the Vermillion Tanagers. This tournament is being conducted under the guidance and regulation of the South Dakota High School Activities Association for the enjoyment and benefit of high school students. Good sportsmanship is essential for the success of these programs. We hope you'll enjoy the games and support your athletes in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. And now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, will you please stand as we honor America? Today, we are proud to present the Lakota Flag Song. The Lakota Flag Song is a musical composition dedicated to honoring the American flag. The Lakota Flag Song will be performed by Nacha Charging Crow and Nathan LeBeau from Pine Ridge. Following the completion of the Lakota Flag Song, please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem performed by Mateo Ward of Belle Fouche. We would remind all in attendance that the proper respect is to face the flag. Remove your hat or cap and stand at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans and active duty military not in uniform may also salute the flag. Ladies and gentlemen, the Lakota Flag Song, followed by the national anthem.
So gallant. Charging Crow and Nathan LeBeau and Mateo Ward. Let's introduce our officials for our first game of the day. The referee, Lee Taylor. The umpires are Luke Anderson and Nick Gottlieb. The alternate official is Christopher Janish. Gentlemen, the alternating starting lineups. First for the Tigers, a sophomore guard at 5'11". Number one, Keegan Tracy. For the Tanagers, a senior guard at 5'11", number 20, Connor Roehrig. For the Tigers, a sophomore guard at 6'3", number four, Ryder Johnson. For the Tanagers, a freshman guard at 6'1", number 22, Bryson Skosberg. For the Tigers, a senior guard at 5'11", number 10, Lane Teets. For the Tanagers, a senior guard at 6'1", number 23, Zone Robinson. For the Tigers, a senior guard at 5'11", number 22, Jacob Zack. For the Tanagers, a junior guard at 6'3", number 24, Carter Hansen. For the Tigers, a senior center at 6'2", number 42, Logan Ringenberg. And for the Tanagers, a sophomore guard at 6'3", number 33, Trey Hansen. The head coach for the Groton Area Tigers is Brian Dolan. The head coach for the Vermillion Tanagers is Jay Drake. Tigers fans, are you ready? Tanagers fans, are you ready?
Nate, these two teams did play each other during the regular season, and it was a Vermillion win over Groton Area by 9, and that was in early February.
Yeah, and Groton had jumped on them 18-4 that game, and Vermillion clawed its way back and found a way. Look for Groton to really try to get number 10, Lane Teets, involved here. If you're Vermillion, they've given up way too many transition baskets, have to convert back defensively.
Groton Area with the ball. Their leading scorer is Lane Teets. He's number 10. He's the one really wants to get off to a good start. You know, he had 11 yesterday, 10 below his average. But he had folks from Sioux Valley in his pocket all day yesterday.
And people have been paying him a lot of attention throughout this entire tournament.
It will stay with Vermillion. Trey Hansen, number 33, he's the one inbounding. He's the leading scorer for the Tanagers.
And this is where Groton really thrives.
Oh, nice. Yeah. That's Tracy. Oh.
A heck of a pass there by Lane Teets. One hand, right hand, threads it through some bodies.
Nice kick around. All the way up to Lane Teets, and a real quick start. And a timeout taken by Vermillion.
It's about as good of a start for Groton as you can ask for. Get Lane Teets involved. Couple defensive stops, run it out in transition.
How often do you practice this in practice? A 3-on-2 break, good passing. Tracy with the basket.
Yeah, and it's been something that Vermillion has really struggled with this entire tournament is converting back on defense. We talked about the teams are shooting at extremely high percentages against them in this tournament, both Sioux Falls Christian and Pine Ridge, and more of the same so far early today. See Groton in a little three-quarter court trap. There's a nice drop off.
It's Connor Roehrig, his first basket.
Skogsberg with the nice attack and drop off to Roehrig.
Teets. And Lane is up to 7 points. He had 12 on Thursday, 11 yesterday. Oh, nice drive. Oh. Roehrig's gonna go to the line. Count the basket.
Yeah, and Roehrig's been a guy for him or for them who hasn't been super aggressive with the ball in his hands. He's more kind of a play finisher rather than a play creator, but there he attacks hard and with the nice lefty finish.
Deagle coming in for Groton area. And for Connor Roehrig, this will be his first free throw of the tournament. Wants to complete that three-point play. 5 points for Roehrig.
Yeah, and when Vermillion's operating at their best, they're getting the Hansons, Trey and Carter, and Skogsberg, and then getting some production from those auxiliary players like Roehrig and Zone Robinson.
Saved by Deagle to Tracy. Another timeout gonna be taken by Vermillion. Well, Vermillion's kind of been punched in the mouth here. How are they gonna respond?
Yeah, it doesn't appear that Coach Drake is too pleased so far with the early effort and early intensity. And then you got the other side of the coin with Groton that's certainly ready to play on both sides of the floor, pushing it offensively, moving, connected defensively. And it's the second time out that Vermillion's trying to change things. And at some point as a coach, you can only do so much. You're not out there running around making the plays. These guys got to find it within themselves to change the momentum.
Kind of have to get out of your mind that, yeah, you're playing for seventh, but you're playing a game.
Playing a game. If you're a competitor, if you're a true competitor, I don't care whether it's basketball or anything, but you get a chance to that competition piece and go against somebody else, and you want to represent yourself, your team, your program in a positive manner.
Deagle with the foul, his first. Here's Trey Hansen.
Yeah, Groton just doing it. They're switching a lot of actions, doing a good job of keeping the ball outside of the paint. There's Zone Robinson with the nice cut.
Nice. Zone Robinson, his first basket. The kick to Tracy. And the putback by Jacob Zach.
Groton off to a hot 6 of 7 start from the floor.
Had a lane, but couldn't drop it. And the drive, it's gonna be Zach going to the free throw line, but we've got a break. First game of the day, it's
seventh place game here at the State A's.
As much as you have accomplished, there are times you'd rather not go it alone. While you determine what direction you go, we're here to help along the way. So go. Go with community. Go with neighbors. Go with understanding. Go with support.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
And welcome back. Stacey Jones here taking a look at the Vermillion bench. Now, this is their 14th appearance in the state tournament, their first since 2021. They picked up a couple of titles back in 1988 and 1989, runner-up back in 1950.
Skogsberg at the line, the lefty.
Yeah, and visiting with Coach Drake before the tournament, he said, it's a little bit more of a unique team for them because they've always kind of hung their hat on being a hard-nosed, disciplined, defensive team. And this one's probably been able to score it better than some of his other ones, but it's kind of been up and down on what they're providing on the defensive end. And we've seen that here a little bit this tournament.
Teets with the three. Hansen on the rebound. On the timeout, even some of the assistant coaches for Vermillion trying to keep the guys motivated, excited.
Yeah, you're trying to push whatever buttons you can when you just feel like you're maybe not playing up to your potential.
Teets being guarded by Carter Hansen. Oh, Teets. The high jumper.
Yeah, he's just so good when he's got the basketball in his hands. And we've seen it in a couple early games this tournament. Teams have,
jump ball.
Yeah. It's good. Ryder Johnson there steps in from the gap and ties up the ball. But yeah, most teams have tried to keep the basketball, and there you can see it on the replay. But defensively, they try to keep it out of Lane Teets' hands as much as they can.
The block from Ryder Johnson. Teets is the leading three-point shooter for the Tigers. And a foul on Deagle, and for Taylor, that's his second. Colby Dunker will report in for Groton area. And for Vermillion, Landon Cerny. Vermillion got out to a 7-0 deficit, but with a basket here, make it a 4 or 5 point game. Oh, there's Teets with the steal. The finish and going to the line.
Lane Teets did a nice job of just jump switching that handoff and ends up creating a turnover. And as we've mentioned a bunch, when he gets out in the open floor, so dynamic, so hard to stop.
Cole Tweeten coming in for the Tanagers. Cole has seen action in both tournament games. Teets is an 82% free throw shooter.
Right now for Vermillion, the Hansons, Carter and Trey, who both combined average about 34 points a game, are 0-5, and neither one of them in the scorebook so far.
Robinson, guarded by Teets. Oh, Robinson with a nice strong move to the basket. His second basket. Boy, Teets has been active. Over to Johnson. And Ryder gets it blocked by Tweeten.
Tweeten comes over from the weak side there. Meets him up top. Still 17 on the shot clock.
Over to Johnson. Tanager's in transition.
Yeah, Johnson, who had 19 yesterday and 7 rebounds. Kind of a quiet, start so far for him, but mainly Lane Teets and Keegan Tracy has 4. Jacob Zach 2.
Groton area brings in Kaysen Keough. Keough is a 5'10 sophomore.
And whenever Carter Hansen's in the game, they're trying to put him on Lane Teets. He's got good length.
Landon Cerny picking up the foul for Vermillion. His first.
Second team foul of the quarter.
Teets being guarded by Carter Hansen and the blocking foul.
We were just a little late filling over with that baseline help and couldn't quite beat him to the spot.
Cerny on the foul, his second. Lane Teets, 7 of 8 from the free throw line for the tournament.
Zone
Robinson coming in. He's got a couple of baskets here in this first quarter.
Lane's been a big part of this program. When they made the state tournament 2 years ago, he was a sophomore. That was an integral part of that team, and he's led him back here this year as a senior. And they talked a lot about their season has been so successful because he's developed a trust in his teammates, and he doesn't need to average 27, 28 points a game any longer. You know, he's averaging 20 a game, but then they have those other role guys, and they've just developed some of those younger weapons, especially like a Ryder Johnson, obviously Jacob Zach and Keegan Tracy and those guys. Much harder to defend when you're a multifaceted offensive team.
Teets with the rebound. You saw him with the swat defensively on the prior possession.
It's a good wall up there by Cole Tweeten.
Foul on the Tanagers. It's going to go on Trey Hansen, his first. Oh, nice play. Right to Teets.
They fake the up screen, and then Teets just turns right back to the rim. Little run and jump action.
Robinson trying to help Vermillion get things rolling. He's got 7 of their 14 points. Robinson's first 3 of the game. Offensive foul on Ryder Johnson.
It's a good job by Bryson Skolesberg. Bracing for the contact and taking it right in the chest.
Logan Ringenberg is back in for Groton area. Trey Hansen.
double high ball screen for Trey Hansen. Oh, carried the ball. Turnover. It's the fifth turnover by the Tanagers here in the opening quarter.
Coming up under a minute here.
Boy, good hold by Teets. He was trying to wait and wait till the last second. Just didn't have enough strength on the left-handed layup.
He may have gotten away with a little double dribble there. That right hand was got a piece of that basketball as it was going down on the floor as well. Shot clock's off here. They can hold for one if they choose.
Robinson with Hansen. That's Carter. That's Trey Hansen. Skogsberg is the leading three-point shooter for Vermillion. Well, Groton will get a chance for last shot.
A little miscommunication there. Trey Hansen thought Zona Robinson was going to drift to the corner, and he was actually lifting up out of the wind.
Turner Thompson coming in off the bench for Groton. Coach Dolan told him to hurry up and get in, had his warm-up jersey on. He's got the ball. Go ahead, launch it. Oh, it was online, but just short. We're done with the first quarter of our seventh place game.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
At Bank West, our relationships are everything. They reach beyond banking. We're committed to understanding your vision and upholding your values as partners in your success. Building a future filled with opportunity. Bank West.
And welcome back. You're taking a look at Groton's coach, Brian Dolan. Now, he's been a coach both on the collegiate and high school level. He was the head men's basketball coach at Upper Iowa in Iowa and also at Wayne State in Nebraska. Recently, he was the head boys coach at Aberdeen-Roncalli for a couple of years, now his fifth year at Groton area. And he spent a lot of time on the road with you, Nate.
We spent a few days in gymnasiums together recruiting players, never together. But yeah, we developed a good friendship. I consider him a friend. He's a really good basketball coach, and he's done a nice job with this Groton program.
Here's Lane Teets. Tracy. Ringenberg getting the rebound. Trying to keep it alive. Runs out of space.
Ringenberg had using the size there. Using the size.
Tweeting back in for Vermillion.
Ringberg looks like he could also maybe double as an offensive guard or offensive tackle.
Oh, yeah.
Tackle. Imagine he moves some bodies out on the gridiron.
Go,
Rohrig. Robinson.
You see Groton just so versatile in their switches.
That travel.
Yeah. Doing a good job of just keeping the basketball in front of them right now. And they've forced Vermillion already into 8 turnovers here. Not even halfway through the second quarter.
Good defensive play by Robinson.
Quick hands there by Zone Robinson, stripping that basketball.
Trey Hansen in trouble. Rebound by Jacob Zach. Up to Keegan Tracy, and he's going to go to the line. Chance for a 3-point play.
Points in transition. Groton doing a great job of pushing the basketball, getting multiple numbers advantages.
And we got a bloody nose for Trey Hansen.
Count the basket. At the line, Keegan Tracy shoot one shot.
Looks like more than lip, something in the mouth. So if they can't stop the bleeding here real quick, he has to come out. Officials looking at it. Yep, good. He's good. We've seen a couple of times players having to go to the bench because bloody nose.
It's what you expect at a state tournament, Craig. Hard-nosed, battles, people competing, bodies flying everywhere, little blood spattering.
7 points for Keegan Tracy.
Yeah, if you can, when you're getting Groton's running and jumping there, and you want to be able to, if you pass out of it, try to attack and make him pay for making those decisions.
Stolen by Johnson, and then double dribble. Dunker back in for the Tigers. Groton area has been playing fast defensively. Haven't allowed too many drives to the basket.
No, they've been doing a really nice job of keeping the basketball out of the paint on the drive. Vermillion's had a little success cutting in behind them for a couple high-quality chances, but forcing them into their 9th turnover now.
Johnson and Tracy. That's Dunker. Teets with the ball. Gets the shooter's touch. His second three of the game, 18 points for Teets in the first half.
Yeah, and we're seeing what he's capable of, and they're getting him involved and getting him more touches than he was gotten in their 2 previous games.
Hansen being guarded by Zach. Air ball. Lane Teets, 5'11 senior. The dish to Johnson. His first basket of the game. Rohrig, he wants 3 ball and he gets it. His first 3 of the game.
Nice driving kick. Skogersberg finds Rohrig. Knocks it down.
His second tray of the tournament. Download a Dunker. Yeah!
things are going right now for the Tigers. Some friendly bounces, friendly rolls, but they're earning it. Competing hard, running crisp offense, setting physical screens.
Yo! Skogsberg gets his first basket, reaching as far out as he could to get the layup. Dunker! Two straight baskets there, for Colby.
There you can see Lane Teets keeping that primary defender who went over the top of the ball screen, keeping him on his back. And a hostage dribbling for a bounce or two and then finding that roll guy.
Roerig, the kick to Skogsberg. Teets. 20 points.
Right now, Groton area shooting over 60% from the floor. And they're only 2 of 8 from three. From two, they have missed four shots the entire game from two right now. 14 of 18 from two.
www.sdguard.com. South Carolina High School Activities Association invites you to share a photo or text your favorite tournament experience or traditions with Boys State basketball fans everywhere. Use the hashtag SDHSAA.
Nice crowd from Groton here this afternoon.
Trying to cheer their Tigers on to one last victory here this year. And in Groton area, six of their last six from the floor. And as you mentioned, we're seeing the Lane Teets already has met his season average here. 8 of 11 from the floor, 20 points total. They're getting pretty much anything they want offensively. They're able to move the ball where they want. Their play design, the guys cutting off the screens that they want to find are there. And it's kind of what we talked about as we were getting started this afternoon, that Vermillion just hasn't been as connected and together as you need to be at a state tournament defensively.
I think Jay Drake was trying to wait for the media timeout. He couldn't wait any longer. Got the media timeout now. We're in Rapid City, the Class A boys basketball tournament.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great. Like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
A community is more than buildings. It's where you live, where you work. Community is being there for each other. Lending a hand when your neighbors are in need. Community is all of us coming together for a greater purpose. This is community. This is Lloyd.
On the right, the Groton area fans and some of the Vermillion girls basketball players there on the left. After winning a state title last week.
Yeah, exciting times. Both teams making the state tournament.
Well, and kudos to the Tanager fans. I mean, traveling two weekends in a row, some of the fans, it's not easy. Not easy. On the road two weekends in a row.
March Madness, Craig. No better time of the year. Find a way. Who needs to work?
And no snowstorm, that helps. Three, Roerig with his second tray of the game. He's got 11.
Yeah, right now, Roerig in Zone Robinson. Roerig with 11, Zone Robinson with 7. The usual customers, the Hansons, Trey and Carter, still scoreless.
Hanson with the rebound. And the foul on Dunker, and for Colby, his first.
Five, Colby
for Groton area, Jacob Zach. He is a 13 points a game scorer. He's got one basket.
Yeah, Jacob Zach, I know this Groton staff thinks he's one of the better defenders in the entire state. So good laterally. That has good instincts, anticipation.
It's Henson. Oh, Carter can't get it to roll. Four against two. Teets will take three ball. I think he's kind of feeling it today. Yeah, 23 points here in the first half.
The rim is looking big for Lane Teets right now.
Skogsberg, the hand check. Gonna be on Groton area and on Turner Thompson.
Jacob Zach is second, 13 foul of the quarter.
Actually, the foul's going to go on Jacob Zach. Here's Johnson back in. His dad, of course, the all-time leading scorer for Groton.
That's some good bloodlines.
And a hold. That one is on Thompson. His first.
It was a nice backdoor cut by Skogsberg, and they had to grab onto the jersey.
That one's tipped up by Johnson. Another turnover. This is Deagle. And zone. Jumping over the bench to try to save the ball. Gage Sipple comes in. We saw Gage yesterday. He kind of was. Had to go up against one of the bigs for Sioux Valley yesterday.
Yeah, he had the Alex Squires task, so it was getting plenty of minutes. There he is on the offensive glass, making an immediate impact. He's a good-looking kid, 6'6", only a sophomore. Got a sturdy frame on him.
Zone to Hansen. Oh, a double team, but there's Roehrig, and he'll go to the line to shoot two. Vermillion three for three from the free throw line here in this first half.
15 foul in the quarter, two shots for Connor Roehrig.
Didn't shoot any free throws yesterday or Thursday in the tournament, but now he's already two for two in this one. As you saw, Groton area's Kaysen Keogh in the game. 13 for Roehrig.
Yeah, and it's really, you know, they're shooting over 40% from the floor. Just defensively, they're allowing 60%, and they've had 10 turnovers. It's been the reason for the disparity in the score right now. Tanagers have some fouls to give here. That was only their second team foul here in this quarter.
Timeout here by Coach Dolan. The foul was on Zone Robinson, his first. Pretty good offensive output for Groton area in this first half. They average 67 points a game, and here they are with 42 in the first half.
Yeah, they've been operating on all cylinders, and really they're only 3 of 11 from 3 at 27%, but their two-point field goal percentage right now is they've just been getting whatever they want. Wherever they want to move that basketball, they're finding cutters. They're getting transition baskets, offensive rebounds, scored in a multitude of ways.
Let's see what Coach Dolan has written up for them here in the last seconds of the half. Oh, and carry. Tanager ball.
Still got 6 seconds here. Plenty of time to try to catch it with your momentum going down the floor if you can.
Oh, stolen by Keo. Tracy. Oh, simple. Oh, he can't get it. Oh. 3-point blank shots missed, but Groton area with the lead here at the half. As they score 21 points in the first quarter, and they scored 21 points in the second quarter.
Consistent.
Vermillion, by the way, they had 14 points in the first quarter, and they scored 10 in the second quarter. Brian Dolan is with Stacy Jones.
All right, Brian, the guys came ready to play. They want to finish this tournament on a good note.
Yeah, absolutely. We were in this game 2 years ago. You don't want to go over when you're here, but, you know, we feel like we didn't play great yesterday. We wanted to show everybody that we're a little better than yesterday, and the kids have a lot of pride, and our community's awesome. And we want to support them just like they're supporting us.
How are you feeling about the first half?
I feel pretty good. A couple down here on defense where we didn't secure possession, and they got some second chance points or got some easy buckets. We got to take those away. But offensively, we're just going to keep pushing the basketball and make them get back on defense and keep trying to get to that basket.
All right, we'll see you in the second half.
Thank you.
We'll have more from the Summit Arena inside the Monument after this.
You live life on the move. While you determine what direction that may be, we're here to help along the way. So go. Go with values. Go with friends. Go with support. Go with convenience.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our livestock, our pigs, is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy, so we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
Coverage of the South Dakota High School Activities Association event is made possible by a partnership between the SDHSAA and SDPB. Sponsors of SDPB's coverage include Dakota Bank, South Dakota Corn, and by Lloyd Companies, Bank West, South Dakota State University, the South Dakota Department of Education, and by your membership in the Friends of SDPB.
Welcome back to Rapid City. We're at halftime here between the 7th and 8th game. Well, with all sports, there are challenges that come along with it. For a senior at Brandon Valley, one key challenge extends beyond the court.
The sounds of the game of basketball are familiar to the Althoff family.
You know, whether it's the PA announcers, you know, introducing the players. The cheerleaders leading the cheers. It's been something that has kind of resonated with us, I think, here these last few years for sure.
The Althoffs' love of the game continued on with all of their children. including the youngest, Josh.
My brothers always played growing up, so I always went to their games and just had fun watching them, so I figured I'd play.
While Josh appreciates the game of basketball, he's got a greater appreciation for the sounds of the game, as he was born deaf.
Every newborn, turns out, is screened for hearing. And when she did Josh's hearing screening, she did not find any vibrations or brain waves that he was hearing sound. So she let me know that she had serious concerns about significant hearing loss in both ears. And that was all the information we were given before he was discharged from the hospital. And that started us on our journey of having him evaluated and figuring out that he had a profound hearing loss.
With a lot of research and a new job opportunity for Brent in Memphis, Tennessee, the Althoffs were able to find a way for Josh to hear with a cochlear implant.
The blessing was that in Sioux Falls, there was a physician who would do the cochlear implant surgery, but he would not do it in Sioux Falls, and he'd only done 6 patients. When we got to Memphis, we got him at to be seen by a physician who had implanted over 160 kids. And it was the surgery ended up being at the Children's Hospital, and he was able to get both sides implanted at once.
We did a lot of research, considered the impact of, raising, a son through the deaf community versus, the cochlear implant option. And, it wasn't an easy decision. We didn't know what was truly best for him, but having older brothers, we just felt that, the cochlear implant would be a better option for our family and, trusted in God.
I'm definitely happy that they did, because without it, there's a lot of things about my life that would have been different, a lot of things that I wouldn't have been able to do. So I'm definitely happy for sure.
Now Josh is leading the links on the hardwood with full hearing, as long as he's got his ears on.
You really don't notice it a whole lot. It might fall off once in a while if he gets hit hard on a foul or something like that, but the guys are good at relaying the information, making sure if he's on the other end of the court that they're saying it a second or third time closer to him, get the message passed. He's good at just looking and dialing in and reading lips like everybody should, but he's really learned that he's got to really have eye focus and make sure he's doing that. But man, the expectations are just the same, and Josh wouldn't have it any other way.
Just that as long as you got the right attitude and the right work ethic, they can't really hold you back. It means a lot, because without the cochlear implants, I wouldn't be able to hear that. And it just reminds me that it's kind of a gift that I've been given, so I'm very thankful for it.
And Josh and Brandon Valley taking on Mitchell tonight in the state AA tournament. Well, SDPB recently produced a program entitled Tales from the Hardwood, which featured Josh's story among many others. Go to sdpb.org/basketball and watch Tales from the Hardwood today. We'll be back with the second half right after this.
At Bank West, our relationships are everything. They reach beyond banking. We're committed to understanding your vision and upholding your values as partners in your success. Building a future filled with opportunity. Bank West.
There is a new world out there, revealing itself in unpredictable ways. A world that demands more from the land and those who grow, farm, and build on it. This new world calls for the ingenuity to get more out of it while preserving as much as we can. After all, to stay ahead of tomorrow, we need to be equipped for it today.
Dakota Plains New Holland dealers proudly support high school athletics.
We're all going somewhere, going higher, faster, farther, going in new directions, to new places. At Monument Health, we keep going so you can keep going. We're dedicated to advanced orthopedic care with the latest innovations, technology, expertise, and treatment. So keep exploring, keep making memories, keep going with Monument Health as your partner. Learn more at monument.health/orthopedics.
Anthem Oats in Frederick is a proud community partner and supports high school activities in South Dakota. The Sumptions have been stewards of the soil since 1882. From the family farm right to your pantry, anthemoats.com.
First Dakota is here for the shared community experiences, the competition, long-standing rivalries, the players and coaches, seeing friends again, and cheering on our favorite teams. It's what makes life great here, and First Dakota is here for it.
Getting ready to start the third quarter of our seventh place game between Groton Area and Vermillion. Groton Area got off to a blistering start in that first half. They get out to a 7-0 lead. They extended the lead to a dozen. Lane Teets getting it done for Groton Area. His first three of the game, and then would have two more later to finish with 23 in that first half. Vermillion, Connor Roerig had a nice first half, leading the way with 13, and Zone Robinson with 7. Keegan Tracy with 7 points in that first half. Yeah, Roerig has not missed a shot. 4 of 4 from the field, 2 of 2 from 3. 3 of 3 from the foul line, trying his best to keep Vermillion around. As we come back, Groton Area picking up the foul. This is Trey Hansen at the line, and Trey gets his first point of the game. He's the leading scorer for the Tanagers. Challenging first half for Trey.
Groton's really been keying on him and keeping the basketball. He's such effective. And there's Tracy, a little strong on the look.
Third rebound for Trey Hansen. And Trey's gonna pick up the foul on the hold.
Yeah, I was saying that Trey Hansen, he's so effective putting the ball on the floor and getting to the rim and drawing fouls. And we've talked a lot about his prowess getting to the free throw line. And Groton's just, they've done a very good job of keeping his action in front, sliding their feet and making life hard for him.
Trey Hansen, by the way, his third foul. Skogsberg.
Skogsberg loaded that one up from about 25, 26 feet. That was well behind the NBA line.
To Zach, elbow shot there. And a timeout by Groton Area.
30-second timeout.
I think Coach Dolan's talking about a little something defensively right now for them that he saw. Groton does, they switch a lot of different actions, especially 1-2-4. They got some versatile guys with Ringenberg or Dunker or Sipple in. They're a little bit different, but those other four, a lot of the times that they put on the floor, whether it's Tracy, Lane Teets, Ryder Johnson, Jacob Zach, they're all just able to, so versatile and quick laterally that they can guard a lot of different guys.
We know who's the Tiger now.
love the Tiger mascot.
And Trey, can't get it to go. Hard work by Trey Hansen. Keegan Tracy, that's his first three of the game.
Poise and patience there by Lane Teets. Not only has Lane scored 23 points, but that was his fourth assist of the game. He can both create for himself, create for others. Such a big part of this Groton offense. Nice move. Branson Skogsberg.
Yeah, you haven't seen too many baskets like that for the Tanagers here this game.
Transition.
Tried to go a little quick give and go.
Watch out. Oh. Oh. That one hurt. Johnson took one in the head. And he'll pick up the foul.
Yeah, and yesterday, if you recall, he was out for a little while of that Pine Ridge game with kind of a similar deal, but then checked back in and ended up clearly feeling okay, as he was really productive yesterday for him with 19 points and 7 rebounds.
Talk a little bit about, of course, Ryder's dad, JR. He's the all-time scorer for Groton. He scored 1,626 points in his career at Groton. He missed part of yesterday's game a little bit.
He did, yeah.
Took a drive into the lane and fall into the floor against the standard and was out for a little bit, but did come back.
Yeah. This one, I think he almost made contact with one of the Vermillion players' knees or legs that ended up maybe hitting his head. And yesterday it was just his little collapsing on the floor.
Yeah, we're going to take him to the locker room. And Ryder had a double-double versus Aberdeen Roncalli in the region semifinals, and had 20 in the Sodak 16 against Del Rapids.
Substitution.
Averaging 10 points a game.
Yeah, talented sophomore for the Tigers, and he actually ended up playing quite a bit for them last year, even as a freshman. And even though he's a younger guy, he's got plenty of experience here so far early in his high school career.
We'll stay with Vermillion. Lobbed right to Tracy. Go to Vermillion. Here's Rohrig. Rebound by Tracy.
Yeah, and those are the opportunities that Trey Hansen is normally either finishing or finding his way to the free throw line.
Baseline jumper is good. Jacob Zach, that's his third basket.
Almost looked like he was looking for a pass there. Somebody passed you and said, hey, you know what? I'll just I'll fire this one up.
Timeout on the court. Playing for seventh place. Still to come, the consolation championship.
We're trying to promote the Descendants of Doom tour, you know, trying to make everybody look kind of metal and, you know.
Menacing.
The band just got covered by Delta Dental, so they kind of can't stop smiling.
They need to look more metal, and they don't look metal. What do we do?
Pop off a few more, see what we get.
Give me some metal.
All right, yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Delta Dental!
Oh my goodness.
And welcome back. We've been talking about this a lot during the state tournament. All the family connections, and there's another one out there right now for Groton area, Lane Teets and Ryder Johnson. Now, Ryder Johnson and Lane Teets' dads, J.R. Johnson and Tom Teets, played together in the 1998 state tournament. So they both commented on how that's been really special for them, kind of helping their dads relive some of the state tournament memories as well.
This is Zone Robinson. He is 3 of 6 from the line for the tournament. 0 for 2 today, but he's got 7 points. Trying to keep Tanagers in the game here. There's Rohrig. Rohrig has 13. Rohrig averages 5 a game. He had 13 in that first half.
Yeah, and Vermillion offensively, they're going to spread. They're going to spread the court. 5-out motion. They really try to attack gaps off the dribble. And this afternoon, Groton just done a tremendous job of staying in front of the basketball. There they switch out, as you can see. Switch back, yep.
Kick back to Hansen. And it will be Groton ball. Yeah, Groton has the distinction of playing 5 of the teams in the state tournament during the regular, 4 of the teams during the regular season, and then you added Sioux Valley last night. The basket by Bryson Skogsberg. 8 points for the freshman.
Yeah, Groton certainly felt like they were battle-tested coming in, and as you mentioned, seeing a few of those. And
up to Carter Hansen, and Carter is fouled. He's gonna get 2 shots. That is the 5th team foul on Groton area, so that puts the Tanagers at the line for the rest of the quarter with 2 free throws. And it's his first trip to the line today.
Just not a whole lot that's been going really right for the Tanagers so far today, as they've missed their last 3 free throws and 13 turnovers. There, they finally get one to go.
Vermillion went 6 of 6 from the free throw line in the first half. They're now 1 and 4 in the second half. And it's gonna be Carter Hansen with the foul.
Yeah, and Carter Hansen's been the one tasked with trying to contain Lane Teets. And a little bit of a difference from Vermillion to the other teams that Groton, Hamlin, and Pine Ridge, that both of them tried to just keep the ball out of Lane Teets' hands as much as possible, whereas Vermillion's just playing more, just kind of true to the system, keeping them in front, and he's made them pay.
The kick. Off the mark by Thompson.
It's a good board by Trey Hansen there, going up and getting it above 3-4 bodies. He averages 7 rebounds a game, and that's been something this tournament. He's yesterday he had 20 points, 11 rebounds, and so far today the offense isn't happening for him, but he has 6 rebounds.
Trey Hansen. Lane Teets with his 3rd foul. At the line, Trey Hansen. 1 for 1 today.
Back on the floor, Cole
Tweeten back in for Vermillion. Groton area brings Blake Pauly. We saw Blake yesterday. I have a feeling we're going to see the benches cleared in this game. Everybody's going to get a chance to play.
I think people are going to be
get some opportunity, certainly if the score stays similar to this.
2 points on the day for Trey Hansen, all of them free throws. And it's an offensive foul on Teets. That'll be his fourth.
Cole Tweeten, we were maybe turning there a little bit, but he beat him there, was sad, was just kind of turning that chest a little bit, made it appear a bit more awkward. But Cole Tweetens came over and drawn a charge, came over and protected the rim with a block shot. It's kind of that last line of defense for the Tanagers. And
big hit. Call it for Trey Hansen. Trey gets to Trey, his first of the day.
First made field goal of the day as well for their leading scorer.
Stays with the Groton area. Simple back in. Gage, 6'6 sophomore, coming in for Dunker.
Yeah, we'll see if the Tanagers can maybe string a few stops together, gather a couple more baskets, and change the flow of this game.
This is Skogsberg. And somebody was out of bounds. It's going to be Tanager ball. See, sitting on the floor and out of bounds.
Oh, they go right back to the inbounder, Trey Hansen.
Offensive foul. Yeah, you saw Trey, and that's going to be his fourth foul. He pushed in. There you saw it with the elbows. He pushed Deagle in the chest.
Yeah, if he would have went right off that pivot and just exploded up, but pivoted and then lowered that shoulder into the body and then tried to go up, and that was an easy one for the officials.
Deagle. Oh, we got a blocking offensive foul here on Groton area. That is on Simple. And for Gage, that is his first.
Zoe Robinson.
Since it's an offensive foul, they won't shoot free throws. But the Tigers have committed 5 team fouls. Any other foul here in the rest of this period, Vermillion will get 2 free throws. He stepped out of bounds. Skogsberg trying to get something going. Ran out of real estate, backboard got in the way.
Yeah, and Groton's gonna end up, as you can see Simple there at the high post, they do a lot of action where they get, he's a main screener and cutters, and there, Jacob Zach just lifts Cole Tweeten up.
Cole, that would be his first foul.
His first, fourth team foul. 2 shots for Jacob Zach.
Always taught, yeah, get your defender off balance and then just shoot up against him and you're going to the free throw line.
Yeah, and as long as they come, if it's not an unnatural motion and balance where you end up, you're the one that creates and initiates the contact. But there, Cole Tweeten was just going right into that shot, right into balance and where your body's at. And those ones are going to get called more often than not.
Zach with 10 points. Shot off by Cerny. Oh, bounces right back to Zach and puts it up and scores.
Second time's the charm. Second time's the charm. tried setting up a little backdoor action there. As a passer, you'd like to be a little bit closer to an operating area there. Carter Hansen was trying to make that pass from about 35 feet away from the basket.
Chance to take the last shot of the quarter. Up, and kicked out, stays with the Tigers. Deagle on the inbound. And the foul on Cole Tweeten. His second.
It's going to be free throws for Jacob Zach. Is that their fifth team foul of the quarter?
Jacob Zach, 5'11 senior. He averages 13 a game. He had 8 points on Thursday, 9 yesterday.
Substitution is Bryson Stokesberg.
75% free throw shooter. He was 6 of 9 from the free throw line before today, and today he's 3 for 3.
Yeah, and he's an important part of their program and their success this year. Guy that averaged nearly 14 points a game, 5 rebounds, 3 assists, can shoot over 40% from three, 77 from the foul line. Really good defender.
And 3 quarters.
We're done through three here in Rapid City for 7.
What does primary care mean to us? At Sanford Health, it means being there when and where you need it most. It means building a relationship, because when a provider really knows you, they can deliver the best care for every aspect of your health and your life. So what does primary care mean for you? It means understanding your health for today and for where you're headed next. It means a lifetime of care for a lifetime of you.
Lucky for us, life is full of choices, big and small, just as it should be. They define us, make us who we are. And when it comes time for you to choose, a car, home, your next big adventure, or start a new business, Farmers Union Insurance has the variety of choices to make sure you have the perfect coverage to protect each perfect moment. Farmers Union Insurance.
Jay Drake roaming the sideline there in front of his bench. They really had a rough start with the tournament, Nate. They were sick. They were ill. They didn't get a lot of practice time. They kind of changed their practice schedule. They qualified for the tournament, over a week ago. But then the girls, as there's a basket by Skogsberg, he's got 10. And so they changed their practice a little bit so that the boys could go watch the girls play the State A and win the championship. Well, then right after that, a number of the players were getting sick. There was strep throat and pink eye and the flu. And, only 8 players made it to school for a day or two. And then, of course, drive out to Rapid City and practice on Wednesday of this week. So they've struggled with some health issues this week, but they've toughed it out and playing their third game.
Yeah, you can maybe tell from a preparation standpoint and just a energy and connectedness standpoint. But as Coach Drake said, every team goes through it. The unfortunate part is just the sheer timing of it being state tournament week in the numbers of them. It's one thing if you got 1, 2, 3 guys sick. It's another thing you got half your team that's not feeling like they're able to give their best. And by the sounds of it, it was some of their main guys, that they count on a lot. And you've maybe seen a bit of that, but as we mentioned yesterday, when you get out there, there's no excuses. You got to find a way to
your job zone.
Get it done.
Robinson with 10. And then when you're playing 3 games in 3 days, it adds a little bit. Wouldn't be so bad if you
have a day or two before your next matchup.
Yeah, Coach Drake was mentioning that the coaches were giving some stories about some sick games that they played in high school and college. And then, of course, the iconic Jordan flu game came up against the Utah Jazz. Yeah. Everyone remembers that. That one will go down in history.
Vermillion didn't play that bad in that first quarter against Sioux Falls Christian on Thursday, but Christian was just too much for everybody so far in this tournament. Great block by Zach. And Zone Robinson will pick up the foul. Check that. Robinson with the foul. In the zone, that's his fourth foul. Tanagers will take the timeout.
Probably not a bad foul if you're Zone Robinson there. Just be able to slow him down in transition. Have them take it side out. Be able to set your defense behind you.
Like us on Facebook at www.facebook.com/SDArmyMG.
Things are busy around Rapid City, but things are going to be busy up in Pierre next weekend.
Hey, guess where I'm going to be, Craig?
In the Capital City.
All-State Band is next weekend, but if you can't head to Pierre next weekend, watch South Dakota's finest high school musicians perform at the All-State Band Concert on Saturday, March 23rd at 4 p.m. Central, 3 Mountain. SDPB will live stream the concert that Saturday from the Pierre T.F. Riggs High School. The concert will also be broadcast on April 20th at 8 Central, 7 Mountain on SDPB TV. We are proud of our partnership with the South Dakota High School Activities Association and thankful that we can highlight the artistic talents of young musicians. And as a parent of some young musicians, I greatly appreciate what SDPB does.
It's a great event. Yeah, if you can watch it online, great. If not, it'll be on SDPB on April 20th. Here's Teets. Lane had 23 points in that first half. He has not scored here in the second half. Quick release by Dunker, and for Colby, 6 points.
And they gave Lane a good extended break there in that third quarter and had some other guys out on the court. Here he is back in the fourth.
Oh, what a move. Traffic. Zone Robinson picks up his 12th point.
You can see as this game has went along that those were the type of finishes and layups that Vermillion just wasn't getting early on and in this first half. And they've had a few of those chances here so far in the second.
Teets with his first bucket of the second half. He's got 25. Foul before the shot. Foul on Keegan Tracy.
Keegan Tracy of the Tigers.
Kaysen Keogh coming in for the Tigers.
Kaysen Keogh in the game.
As Deagle comes out.
Oh, nice cut there. I just couldn't handle that. That was a good slash cut by Carter Hansen. Here's Skogsberg.
Oh! A dozen for Skogsberg.
Yeah, the lefty with the nice righty finish there. One stayed right at about 20 for a while. Groton continues to shoot over 50% from the floor and have forced Vermillion into 16 turnovers.
Rebound by Skogsberg. Trey Hansen comes in and gets the roll. Been a tough day for Trey. That's his second field goal. Total of 7 points.
Yeah, and Trey, only a sophomore as their leading scorer, and 7 boards a game. He's got a bright future ahead of him and will be a big part of this Vermillion team and program here for the next couple of years.
Foul by Rorick, and free throws coming up when we come back.
Bioethanol supplies more than just energy. It creates jobs in rural communities. It drives demand for local corn. It provides opportunities for family farms to thrive. To ensure agriculture plays a leading role in the efforts to decarbonize and transition energy, bioethanol remains at the forefront of a pursuit for a cleaner, brighter future for all Americans. Learn how at sdethanol.com.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
Groton area crowd today. Nice attendance here at the monument in Rapid City.
Yeah, the Tiger faithful came out in full force here for their last game of the season here this afternoon.
Keegan Tracy went 4 for 4 from the line yesterday. He is 3 for 3 today. A dozen for Keegan Tracy, 5'11 sophomore. A little trap here by Groton area.
Yeah, not only have those primary defenders been locked in and keeping the ball in front, but one pass away, they're taking away space, and gap defenders are active, trying to build a wall against Vermillion.
Teets. Knocked out by Trey Hansen. Trey, by the way, playing with 4 fouls. Zone Robinson playing with 4 fouls for Vermillion. Lane Teets playing with 4 fouls.
Does look like Ryder Johnson has now came back down on the bench. Certainly not gonna probably play here, but he's at the end of the bench, hopefully feeling better after getting knocked out of the game here in the second half.
The kick to Tracy. 6 on the shot clock. Rorick with the rebound. Rorick, that's his 3rd rebound of the day. And, oh, yeah, it's been that kind of day for Vermillion.
It has been that kind of game. Yeah, that was a nice find by Carter Hance. It looked like Trey was trying to decide whether he was going to go up and try to get a dunk there or just lay it in.
Robinson taking himself. And for zone, 14 points for the 6'1 senior.
And he's been active today. He's been playing hard, making plays defensively.
Vermillion getting ready is 3 ball by Keo. Kaysen Keo with 3 ball, and we're going to get everybody is going to get ready to unload the bench for Groton. Jaden Schwann. First, we'll let both schools give a big applause to their starting 5, their seniors. In fact, Groton area, Stacy, they got a handful of seniors on that roster.
Thank you, seniors.
That's right, Craig. They've got 5 different seniors on this roster. We've seen a lot of them in this tournament. Colby Dunker, Lane Teets, Jacob Zach. We also have Logan Ringenberg and Holden Sippel, all seniors. Vermillion's also losing 4 seniors. Congratulations to them on a great tournament, too. We've got Connor Rorig, Zone Robinson, Wyatt Morse, and Cole Tweeten, all seniors. So some great crowds of seniors on both these teams today.
Thank you, Stacy. This is Easton Weber, tipped away. Trenton Thomas for Vermillion. Leaving it for Cade Rovers. Hunter Morse is going to go to the line. So the foul on Turner Thompson for Groton. A couple sets of brothers there for Groton area. Of course, the Zacks. You got Carson and Jacob, and then, of course, Gage and Holden Sipple. In for Groton area is Logan Ringenberg. He's coming back in. Going out, Turner Thompson. Turner Jr.
And these kids will cherish these moments that they get these last couple minutes playing in a state tournament action.
For Vermillion, we got Cade Rovers, Wyatt Morse.
I think they're trying to get big Ringenberg. He's looking for a three, maybe.
Gabe Larson. Also in the game, Trenton Thomas. How about for Groton area? Back to Turner Thompson coming back in for Groton area. Vermillion, Carson Priester, Luke Jensen, Frankie Orr. Ringenberg comes out for Groton area. You know my thoughts here, there, Nate.
Let her rip.
Let her rip. Doesn't matter what the score is. Just get up there and rip it and throw it in. Get on the scoreboard. Rebound by Frankie Orr of Vermillion. Jump ball. Cade Rovers will inbound for the Tanagers. On top to Carson Priester. There you go. Take the shot. There you go.
Spin back baseline.
Rebound by Holden Sipple. With the ball, adds Easton Weber. Weber being guarded by Rovers. Inside and off the mark by Sipple. Crowd was wanting that one.
The bench was wanting that one. Holden was wanting that one.
Got a foul on the court, and coming in for Groton area will be Blake Pauley. Well, he will be coming in. Here comes another senior off the court, Holden Sipple for Groton area, getting a nice round. Didn't get a lot of playing time here in the tournament, but got a chance to get out there and getting a big hug from the coach.
Get the proper curtain call as a senior coming off the floor for the last time.
There you go, take the shot.
Luke Jensen comes up with the rebound.
You go. Luke Jensen with the basket, and he's gonna go for the three-point play.
Luke, of course, the brother of Brooke Jensen, who was a huge part of the state championship that the Vermillion girls team won last weekend.
A lot of folks will remember his mom, Becky Jensen, the former Becky Flynn from Wakanda. And Groton area will win this one. 67-49 over Vermillion. Groton area will be in seventh place. More to come. Oh, wait, we have the awards ceremony coming in, so we'll stay here. The awards ceremony coming up after every game today.
Yeah, and Groton really needs to feel good about their last game here today. I know that they felt like they maybe didn't play their best yesterday against Pine Ridge, but certainly today shot almost 50% from the floor, held Vermillion to 40%, forced them into 16 turnovers, out-rebounded them. It was a really complete effort on both sides.
And we'll turn it over to Scott Jensen.
Good afternoon. We would like to present the awards to the teams that played for 7th and 8th place. To present the awards are Danny Walking Eagle, Marty Weissmantle, Eric Denning, and Kelly Messmer from the South Dakota High School Activities Association Board of Directors. Assisting with the team awards presentation are representatives from the Activity Association's corporate partners, Tom Weaver of Dakota Bank, and Staff Sergeant Kyle Griffith of the South Dakota Army National Guard. The 8th place team in Class A, the Vermillion Tanagers. Players are Cade Rovers, Landon Cerny, Spencer Blanchett, Hunter Morse, Connor Rohrig, Trenton Thomas, Bryson Skogsberg, Zone Robinson, Carter Hansen, Luke Jensen, Gabe Larson, Trey Hansen, Carson Priester, Frankie Orr, Wyatt Morse, Cole Tweeton, and Sean Doan. Managers are John Manning and Reed Rovers. Assistant coaches are Lewis Budmeyer, John Rovers. And accepting the 8th place trophy, the head coach of the Vermillion Tanagers, Jay Drake. Congratulations. The 7th place team in Class A, the Groton Area Tigers. Players, Keegan Tracy, Blake Pauley, Ryder Johnson, Colby Dunker, the birthday boy, Lane Teets, Kason Keogh, Jaden Schwan, Carson Zach, Easton Weber, Jacob Zach, Logan Warrington, Taylor Deagle, Gage Sipple, Turner Thompson, Holden Sipple, and Logan Ringenberg. Ball boy, Trey Teets, Major Dolan, Statistician Becky Erickson, Manager Braxton Emery, Assistant Coaches Matt Lockey, Kyle Gerlach, and accepting the 7th place trophy on behalf of the Groton Area Tigers, the head coach Brian Dolan. Congratulations. There will be a Groton Area Welcome Home celebration 4:30 on Sunday tomorrow at the Groton High School Arena.
More to come here in Rapid City. In fact, we're getting ready for the Consolation Championship coming up next.
We hope you're a fan of stories about heroes, because we'd like you to meet a few of ours. These folks keep our communities moving forward. They're dedicated to being here for you, navigating change, keeping you secure, and offering a helping hand to those who need it. Heroes come from many walks, ours are here to walk with you. Go with trust. Go with people. Go with Dakota Bank.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
We all need insurance to protect our health, our homes, our belongings, and our businesses. But coverage is just the beginning. You also need the support of professionals who stand by your side to protect what's important to you. Fisher Rounds and Associates combines the coverage you want with the commitment you need. Fisher Rounds and Associates, at your service, at your side.
I was looking for something that was gonna be close to home.
Southeast Tech has definitely helped me. I'm actually doing something that I enjoy.
This is the right place to be.
Get your degree, get to work at Southeast Tech.
Beginning April 6th, watch SDPB Saturday evenings for a new lineup of shows. Start the night laughing with Keeping Up Appearances at 5, 4 Mountain. Then, the drama unfolds with back-to-back episodes of Midsummer Murders tag along with private investigator Alexa Cross in My Life is Murder at 7, 6 Mountain, followed by the fan favorites Doc Martin and Father Brown. Plus, Sister Boniface joins us on Sunday evenings at 6, 5 Mountain.
Back in Rapid City, I'm Craig Maddock with Nate Kading and Stacy Jones. Consolation round this afternoon, and we're getting ready for the Consolation Championship. But first in the seventh place game between Groton Area and Vermillion. Groton Area able to hit from the outside and from the inside. Just continued effort that they continued from the first half today.
Yeah, it was the Lane Teach Show, especially early. Ended up finishing with 25 overall. Jacob Zach with 15. Keegan Tracy with another 12. It was a really a good all-around performance, both offensively and defensively for the Tigers.
Vermillion, they had three in double figures. It was Rohrig and Robinson with 13 and Skogsberg with a dozen.
Pretty complete performance for Groton, forcing Vermillion into the 16 turnovers, holding them to 40% from the floor, and they themselves shooting 48%, and that's how you end up winning by 18.
We'll check in with the teams who will go for the Consolation Championship when we come back.
Our teams are committed to improving quality of life in our communities. Whether we're planning construction concepts, building a new downtown development, bringing new businesses to our communities, or maintaining your apartment home, we believe everyone deserves a well-built and well-managed place to live and work. This is Lloyd.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great, like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
Oh my goodness.
Seriously?
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
Welcome back to Rapid City. We are getting ready for our second game of the afternoon, the Consolation Championship, coming up in just a little bit. Well, it was 1 year ago that Viber Curley Jr. Kobe Sherman was diagnosed with a cancerous tumor in his knee. Let's take a look at how Kobe is continuing to support his team and how the community is rallying around Kobe with support and love as well.
I'm Kobe Sherman. I'm 17 years old and I'm from Viber, South Dakota.
Hard to say when I first met Kobe, I guess. I've been in Viberg since 1999, so as soon as Kobe started school, I guess I was probably there as well.
Long enough to coach more than just one member of the Sherman family, Kobe has followed the footsteps of brothers Grady and Brody.
Brody is his oldest brother. Brody played in a state tournament here in 2019, I think it was, and then Grady was also playing at that time, and Kobe was a manager for us at that time, so I had all three of them together during that year, and then Grady and Kobe played on the same team at state tournament later after that. So
it's just, I've looked up to them and wanted to be like them ever since I was super young.
1 year ago, Kobe led Viber Curley at the State Bees in Aberdeen.
Kobe Sherman!
Against Nick Hansen, he's blocked about three of his shots already. As Sherman gets loose and hits a three.
Well, I call him a sharpshooter in the pregame, and that's exactly what he has been. Sherman, 5 of 8 on threes yesterday, finished the day with 20 points.
After the tournament, Kobe knew manager something was wrong.
We're just going in for a simple MRI. I know I feared it was a torn ACL that I played on all year, and we're just gonna go into an MRI and see what it was all about. And they took the MRI, and that day they feared that it was a tumor, and to hear that news is pretty disheartening, but I mean, it was what it was, and that's kind of how the journey got started. I was diagnosed with osteosarcoma, which is bone cancer, in my left knee, which is the source of the cancer. And it unfortunately spread to my lungs, my vertebrae, and my clavicle. And that's, so they're just working on treatment to get all those under control.
Just a couple weeks before, Kobe had played here in the state tournament, and nobody really would have guessed by watching him. I mean, there were, if you were really noticing, you could tell he was favoring the leg a little bit, but for him to perform the way that he did with the tumor that he had and the size of the tumor that he had in his leg was really phenomenal. And for him to be doing that, you know, he played with it all year long, and he was, I mean, a 40% three-point shooter on the season for us. I mean,
we'll get it over to Sherman.
It's amazing that he was able to play so well and not really let on to anybody, I would say, how much it was bothering him.
I was really looking forward to the next year of just sports and just going into my senior year, hoping to have a really good senior year just throughout everything, not just sports, but with my friends and through school. And unfortunately, it kind of all crashed down, so it was really hard to hear those words that something this bad was gonna happen, but I was up for the journey and I was willing to do whatever it took to win this battle.
Throughout his new journey, Kobe is finding ways to support his team.
I do anything I possibly can for the team. If I need to watch 5 hours of film on Thursday night on the next team that we're playing Friday night, I'll do that. If I need to cheer at the end of the bench and get our bench into it just so we get some momentum, that's what I'll do. And I just try to help in any way that I can and help out the players on the court so they know what they're doing, and just support them as they have supported me through this whole journey.
I know the kids love having him around. I mean, he's a friend to everybody, can talk to anybody, and you know, it's just great to have him around as that extra support, and you know, in some cases, almost like a player coach, really.
And behind Kobe, nonstop support.
there's been multiple schools that have put on fundraisers at proms, put on fundraisers at basketball games, did caps for Kobe at school, did penny wars for me at school. I mean, they've become really creative with what they want to do. And you ask any town in this state, there's a good chance that they did something for me, and I'm very thankful for that.
Kobe's mentality?
Don't take any family time, friend time, any sports, anything you enjoy for granted. Always thank God for that and be grateful for everything that you have, because during this journey, it really has made me feel that I need to be more grateful for the things that I have, not worrying about the things that I don't have. I plan on going to Southeast Tech to get my business administration degree, and then to further after that, I want to go be a teacher at Vibert Hurley, so I'll get my teacher certification. I want to help out others. I want to help out the younger kids. I've always been big into sports, so I want to coach too. So I think it'd be really fun to come back, especially to the community that has supported me the most, and help them out the way that they have helped me out. We got a whole army fighting this battle, and we're gonna win this battle.
SDPB is committed to telling great stories that surround high school sports and activities in South Dakota on a yearly basis. To check out more of our video features, go to sdpb.org/basketball. We're getting ready for our second game of the afternoon. That's coming up next.
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do, and that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
What does primary care mean to us? At Sanford Health, it means being there when and where you need it most. It means building a relationship, because when a provider really knows you, they can deliver the best care for every aspect of your health and your life. So what does primary care mean for you? It means understanding your health for today and for where you're headed next. It means a lifetime of care for a lifetime of you.
Established in 1986, the Great Plains Tribal Leaders Health Board represents 18 tribal communities located in South Dakota, North Dakota, Nebraska, and Iowa. Our vision is that all tribal nations, communities, and citizens achieve optimal wellness through the embrace of traditional cultural values and innovative and holistic healing practices, strengthened by tribal sovereignty. For more information on our grant programs, health services, and career opportunities, visit our website at greatplainstribalhealth.org.
This is the PBS app. It's ready for you whenever you want full episodes of your favorites. Perhaps a little history, or the real story, shows with heart, or the latest news and docs. Even stream your local station live. It's all there waiting for you. So download the PBS app now for everything you love and a whole lot more to explore. Stream anytime, anywhere with the PBS app.
Back in the Summit Arena inside the Monument in Rapid City, getting ready for the Consolation Championship. You see the fans from Pine Ridge there, and there are the fans from Sioux Valley. Let's look at Sioux Valley. How about first the bracket? Here's what's happening today. Here's where everybody went throughout the last couple of days. For Pine Ridge, they get beat by Dakota Valley on Thursday, but then yesterday they take out Vermillion. Sioux Valley lost to Rapid City Christian in a double overtime thriller, but they beat Groton Area yesterday to get to the Consolation Championship. Here's Sioux Valley, their 17th appearance, fifth straight for the Cossacks. No titles for their school. They've been runner-up a couple of times recently in 2021 and 22. You see what they did in the postseason here at the state tournament. Their starters, Maxwell Ingebrigtsen, had 13 yesterday in their win. But Alex Squires, their big guy, 31 points yesterday from the 6'10 senior.
The man in the middle has had two double-doubles so far in both state tournament games. Everything that they do, they want to play through him as much as they can.
And the head coach is Bill Vincent. And they take on the Pine Ridge Thorps. Pine Ridge coming in as the four seed. It is the 24th appearance for Pine Ridge, but first time they've been here since 2019. In the tournament, you see they lost to Dakota Valley, beat Vermillion yesterday. Their starting lineup, Marvin Richard III, 23 points a game. Hollowhorn and Roulard with 11 points apiece. And the head coach is Casey Means. A very energetic, very positive coach. And always been fun to watch Coach Means. Follow SDPB Sports on your mobile device. Check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Let's get the starters from each team. And we'll join Scott Jensen here in Rapid City.
Good afternoon, Summit Arena fans at the Monument in Rapid City and everyone watching all over the world on SDPB. Welcome to the Consolation Championship of the 2024 South Dakota State A Boys Basketball Tournament. Playing for the Consolation Championship, the Sioux Valley Cossacks and the Pine Ridge Thorps. This tournament is being conducted under the guidance and regulation of the South Dakota High School Activities Association for the enjoyment and benefit of high school students. Good sportsmanship is essential for the success of these programs. We hope you'll enjoy the game and support your athletes in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the officials this afternoon. The referee is Aaron Entringer. The umpires are Aaron Vandenberg and Chris Long. The alternate official is Scott Sonny. Gentlemen, let's meet the starting lineups. First for the Cossacks, a senior guard at 6'3", number 4, Max Ingebretson. For the Thorps, a senior guard at 6'3", number 0, Xavier Little. For the Cossacks, a senior guard at 5'10", number 5, Jace Christensen. For the Thorps, a sophomore guard at 6'2", number 1, Marvin Richard III. For the Cossacks, a junior guard at 6'2", number 14, Maverick Nelson. For the Thorps, a junior forward at 6'3", number 3, Dominic Ghostbear. For the Cossacks, a senior forward at 6'4", number 32, Hudson Rusing. For the Thorps, a senior forward at 6'2", number 15, Jalen Rulliard. And for the Cossacks, a senior forward at 6'10", number 35, Alex Squires. And for the Thorps, a senior center at 6'7", number 23, Kanye Hollowhorn. The Sioux Valley Cossacks head coach is Bill Vincent. The Pine Ridge Thorps head coach is Casey Means.
All right, Nate, key of the game here in this Consolation Championship, some size for Sioux Valley, but a lot of speed for Pine Ridge.
Yeah, for Sioux Valley, they want to establish Squires early and often. Certainly defensively, they need to try to make Pine Ridge a half-court ball club. on the other side of things need to be able to contain the big fella, but also rebound the ball. They got to force the Cossacks into one and done. Offensively, they are who they are. They're going to play fast and free. They have an electrifying guard and Marvin Richard the third.
Squires and Hollowhorn will jump. Squires is 6'10", Hollowhorn 6'7". And Aaron Entringer will tip this consolation championship off. I don't think Sioux Valley has lost a tip on the opening tip this year with Squires at 6'10".
Looks like Pine Ridge coming out in a little 1-2-2 half-court zone, and there's Ingebretson.
Rulliard, he has had 10 threes in the game. And Richard, he's had 6 threes in the game. So if you're Sioux Valley, you gotta watch out the perimeter.
Yeah, and Sioux Valley a little fortunate there. They left Marvin Richard the third wide open on the top of the key, just a little off to the right.
Down low, that's what Pine Ridge will need to figure out today with Alex Squires, the big guy in the paint.
And they do a good job at looking at him on a side out of bounds, underneath out of bounds.
Marvin Richard III with his first three of the game.
You see Maverick Nelson, who twisted that ankle a little bit, but came back in yesterday's game, is back in the starting lineup.
And Rulliard, number 15 for Pine Ridge, their top three-point shooter. But anyone on the floor for Pine Ridge could hit it from downtown.
Nice drop off there.
Hollowhorn
playing composed, playing up 2 feet. Finds Hollowhorn for the easy one.
Nelson. Christensen. The Squires at times being fronted. That one knocked away by a little. Little getting the start today over Anthony Steele.
And this is where the Thorpes are just so dangerous.
Oh, step back.
Richard the third at 19 points, 13 rebounds, 7 assists in their win yesterday. It's fun to watch.
Ingebrigtsen. Rebound by Richard. Stolen. And over and back.
Ingebrigtsen was trying to, didn't have any other teammates in the front court.
Hollowhorn. Ingebrigtsen had 13 in yesterday's win. Back to Christensen. Looked at a three from the top of the key. And for Jace, that's his first three of the tournament.
Yeah, Jace Christensen, he had 8 points yesterday, only 4 on Thursday, making an early impact. And you can see Sioux Valley.
Timeout on the court. All tied up early.
Dreamer, doer, difference maker. These are just a few things we look for when growing our team at Dakota Bank. Those with empathy and a commitment to doing what's right build their careers with us. If you're about relationships and helping others, Dakota Bank is calling. Will you answer? Go with integrity. Go with teamwork. Go with Dakota Bank.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
The Cossacks fans here in Rapid City, well represented. And the Thorpes, well represented today. A little closer to get to Rapid City, and they love their basketball, they love their Thorpes.
Yeah, we've got a good crowd on hand here this afternoon. So Sioux Valley, just like they did yesterday, and there they found Roulard. Roulard had 18 in the first quarter yesterday.
Oh, here's Squires, the big guy comes in. Gets his second basket. Pine Ridge has brought in Anthony Steele into the game.
Yeah, Sioux Valley yesterday against Groton, they played that box and one, diamond and one, and they're doing the same thing right now on Marvin Richard III.
That was Steele with the bucket. Right now, Hollowhorn trying to front Squires. Do the best he can to prevent any balls going to him. Squires has Hollowhorn in front of him and another Thorpe behind him. The three from Christensen. How about that? Two threes for him in this game.
And when they're paying the attention that they are to Squires, they were just late on that wing closeout as they were trying to pinch down on the big fella.
Jumper by Ingebrigtsen for Maxwell, his first points.
Yeah, he just extends up so well on that pull-up jumper.
That hit the bottom of the basket.
Hollowhorn with the aggressive take. He kind of got caught in the air and didn't have any teammate to go to. And that's what, it's okay to leave your feet for a pass, but you don't want to have to leave your feet to find a pass, just to make a pass.
Rusink, his first foul. Inside, Marvin Richard III. Oh, that one, lane was wide open. Foul's gonna be on Little, and Squires going to the line.
And we saw that a lot yesterday for Sioux Valley against Groton, that if they get scored on, they do not relax, they get a deep outlet, and the big fella, Alex Squires, does such a good job for a big man of running rim to rim. That over-the-top pass has been good for them.
Brock Christofferson in. Squires a 70% shooter. Steal. Rebound by Squires. Don't know if the Thorpes are going to get many second chances with a 6'10 big guy sitting down there.
The rebounding battle is certainly going to be one to watch here, just with the size differential at the five spot, post spot.
Ingebrigtsen got it. His first three of this game. That's his fifth tray of the tournament.
And Maxwell's had a nice tournament so far at 20 points on Thursday, followed that back up with 13 yesterday. Already up to five.
Rouillard and Jalen, familiar territory for him, hitting from the wing.
And here's Matt Nelson back and forth.
Squires just so dominant in the paint.
Yeah, I think Rouillard likes shooting at the Summit Arena here at the Monument. There's a quick release.
Yeah,
number two.
He has 12 trays in the tournament.
He only had four in the first quarter yesterday.
Nelson, you know what? Let's just throw him up from beyond the arc as a timeout by Pine Ridge. Oh. Jalen Richard hitting two threes in that last roundabout. Christensen gets two, Engerbretson gets one, and now Nelson gets one.
We have some offense here today, Craig. So far, seven combined made threes beyond the two. Sioux Valley shooting 67% from the floor. Pine Ridge just under 47. Up and down action here early.
Pine Ridge yesterday put up 35 threes, made 14. Sioux Valley yesterday only shot 13 times around the perimeter and scored two. So yeah, that performance has been doubled already.
In both of the Pine Ridge State Tournament games so far, they've hit double figure threes, and that's what they do. They like to get up and down, average over 72 points a game.
Hollowhorn against Squires. Hey, that's gonna stay with Pine Ridge.
That was a nice action there with a little pin down and then slip to the rim. Squires just such a force defensively at the rim.
Little. Squires with five rebounds in this first quarter. Squires also trying to set picks around the perimeter.
Thorpe's just then dropped back into a man-to-man there.
Squires and knocked out, stays with Sioux Valley.
It's the fourth offensive rebound already for the Cossacks here in this first quarter.
Oh, quick pass, Hudson Rusick.
Nice, and a little screen-to-screener action.
All five starters have scored for Sioux Valley.
Protecting that inbounder, wants to protect that rim. No passes to the backside. Got shot clock off, can hold for one here.
Boy, big battle down low with Hollowhorn and Squires. It's a big battle away from the ball. But this will be a hand check as Marvin Richard III with his first foul.
Yeah, and this is where Sioux Valley loves to just go directly inside to Squires. There it is.
Alex Squires.
He's got eight.
Pretty easy.
And a foul, a blocking foul at the buzzer. Shot didn't go in, but there's two free throws coming. Five on Squires. His first, and Marvin Richard III will get a couple of free throws here.
Free throw line. Marvin Richard III, two shots.
Sioux Valley players will have to stay on the court. They're not gonna go on the lane, but they still have to stay on the court behind the free throw, behind the three-point arc.
Yeah.
87% free throw shooter. Yeah. 7 for Richard in a fun first quarter of the Consolation Championship.
You've worked hard to build your business, your reputation, your success. Your financial partner should be committed to digging in to drive your vision forward. For 130 years, we've stood by South Dakotans. We've been there. We'll be there. Convenient, connected, committed. Bank West, member FDIC.
A community is more than buildings. It's where you live, where you work. Community is being there for each other. Lending a hand when your neighbors are in need. Community is all of us coming together for a greater purpose. This is community. This is Lloyd.
And welcome back. You're taking a look at one of the legends of South Dakota basketball. That's Lyle Dusty LeBeau. He coached both the Pine Ridge girls and boys teams to state tournaments. Now, Dusty's one of the few coaches who won state tournaments with boys and girls. Dusty took 19 different teams to state tournaments over 26 years, well over 500 wins with both the boys and the girls combined. He's in the South Dakota Sports Hall of Fame, rightfully so. Dusty's boys record, by the way, the boys team, 308-92. That's impressive.
By the way, I talked with Dusty on my podcast that you can find at SDPB Sports/basketball. I talked to Dusty about a year ago, and we talked about his history and what he has meant to Pine Ridge and other schools here and in the state. Great man. And he's a big father figure to Casey Means, the head coach. In fact, his uncle too, but also a big time father figure. Squires now with 10.
And the Thorpes are mixing defenses. They're trying to find something that can slow down the Sioux Valley offense. We've seen a 1-2-2, 2-3. Then they were in man-to-man right there, but they're still finding ways to. There's Hollowhorn that stays with it.
Tried to use the rim to block Squires from being able to block it. Boy, it's getting physical down low with Squires down low, Hollowhorn down there, as well as Roulard.
Yeah, Hollowhorn was trying to do what you want to do. You want to meet and greet that big man before he gets deep into the paint. There they find Schiller. Schiller played an important role in their win yesterday with the defense that he provided on Lane Teets.
Squires didn't see it coming. Ghost Bear.
This is where they're at their best.
Rouillard. Coming up with Ghost Bear to Richard. Try it again. Ghost Bear down low.
It's a scrappy unit.
That's off the mark by Rouillard. And Squires picks up his 9th rebound.
Yeah, we had talked about the importance of Pine Ridge being able to limit Sioux Valley to one shot and done, and Pine Ridge creating some second opportunities themselves.
Pine Ridge brings Xavier Little into the game. And for Sioux Valley, it's Hudson Rusing. Cossacks will try to lob this right to Squires. Throw it up high to Squires right at the basket. We've seen that play.
Yeah, a bunch. There they ran a little screen action.
Squires and Ghost Bear getting tied up down low. Ghost Bear's gonna get the foul. He was behind Squires, as you can see in the bottom of your screen.
Yeah, both guys that were kind of tied up there with their arms. There's the lob to Squires.
Ghost Bear, rebound. Taking it the distance.
Right left Euro step by Ghost Bear. The righty finish. And Hollowhorn's off the court, so they just gotta. Ghost Bear's trying to battle Squires inside, just not leaving his side.
Blocking foul on Ghost Bear. Ghost Bear is 6'3", going up against the 6'10 Squires. And we've got a timeout on the court. Up and down and physical in the Constellation Championship.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
There is a new world out there, revealing itself in unpredictable ways. A world that demands more from the land and those who grow, farm, and build on it. This new world calls for the ingenuity to get more out of it while preserving as much as we can. After all, to stay ahead of tomorrow, we need to be equipped for it today.
Dakota Plains New Holland dealers proudly support high school athletics.
The benches. You gotta wonder how physical this will stay, because Squires, again, you see he's surrounded. He got three Thorpes around him. Going right at him, but they gave it to Rusink, and Rusink with the bucket. That's his second field goal.
Rusink ends up finding a nice angle inside, gathers himself for the easy finish.
The pull up by Steele.
Right now, the Thorpes only shooting 35% from the floor. They're 3 of 12 from 3. They've probably missed a few that they normally would like to put down.
Air ball. A step back for Richard. Let's see, Pine Ridge, 3 of 13 now beyond the arc. Ghost Bear, that's his fifth rebound of the game. Oh, and he threw the ball away.
And that's the pace that they want to play at. They certainly want to try to attack the Cossack defense before they're set and back, and especially with big 35 man in the rim.
And Ghost Bear doing what he can against Squires. Playing physical.
They had that back screen there. They were fortunate that Xavier Little got a piece of that pass that Ingebretson was trying to make over the top.
This is Ingebretson, held up there by LeBeau. Physical play. This is what the Thorpes like.
Yeah, Coach Vincent wants to settle him down here, running an action.
6 to shoot.
Good defensive possession here for the Thorps. See if they can finish it.
And they will. And Casey Means is excited. The head coach. He brings that level of excitement and motivation. He wants energy. He wants motivation from his players. And I asked him, well, where do they get their energy? He goes, from me.
The team definitely takes on his personality. Here's Sioux Valley, just 1-2-2, half court zone.
That's Rusink with the block.
The Thorps just have multiple guys that are just fearless attacking the paint. One block shot's not gonna deter them.
Basically, they've got five guards out there.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons why it makes them really difficult to defend. Here they set ball screen for Richard.
Traveled. Nope. They're gonna call the foul.
Foul
on Rusink.
The second quarter.
Yeah, the Thorps are probably a little fortunate there as he got away with an extra half step.
Correction, the foul was on number 23.
Okay, not on Rusink.
His first.
Brock Christofferson with the foul, his first, instead of Rusink. Rouillard, that's his third.
Corner pockets. He loves the corner pockets. Right corner, left corner. He's got such a quick release too when he catches.
Marvin Richards the third with a great save to Rouillard. Back to Richard. Blocked by Schiller. And the foul. And a warning given to the coaching staff of Sioux Valley. Things are heating up here in Rapid City.
Yeah, Richard with the aggressive attack there. The Coach Vincent and the Sioux Valley staff thought it was a clean block up top.
In for the Thorps, Hollowhorn. Going out as a ghost bear. Oh, he worked so hard. He was the guy that, his job was to go up against Squires. Richard the third is 4-for-4 from the line, 9 points. And the 7-point deficit for Pine Ridge is down to 2.
Hollowhorn back in.
Oh, deep three. NBA three. Steal the Hollowhorn, challenging. That one didn't get blocked yet.
Right now the Cossacks are over a 3-minute scoring drought. And Max Ingram, Maxwell into Brexton.
He's got
7 points.
Helps
that out.
Quick hands.
Go right into him. Come
Squires
on the double team.
Marvin Richard the third will pick up his second foul.
When you got a guy like Alex Squires at 6'10 and strong and can score in there, they're just, they've seen every different type of defense at this point in the season. You can see how well schooled and how well coached they are when that double team comes. Schiller's right, block to block, and dump right off to wind his way to the foul line.
Christensen and Nelson are back in for Sioux Valley. Cossacks are 0-for-3 from the free throw line.
Schiller in the 2 games so far this tournament had 9 points on Thursday, 7 yesterday, and was key defensively, as we mentioned. He was the one tasked a lot of the times with chasing Lane Teets around.
Oh, that's the second three by Richard the third. He's got a dozen in the first half. And an offensive foul on Bowden Schiller. That's his second.
Yeah, it looked like he was a bit out of control there as he was attacking to his strong left hand. Marvin Richards was able to beat him to the spot.
Hollowhorn blocked by Squires. Oh, loose ball with Christensen to finish. He's got 8 points.
They got Rouillard in the corner, and they find him.
Schiller with a rebound.
Call for the high ball screen. Would like it to be in Ingebretson's hands. Or he's off the floor, never mind.
Schiller at the buzzer. What a first half. A fun first half with Sioux Valley and Pine Ridge going at it here in the first half. And
Travis. Yeah, it looks like Stacy's going to visit with Travis Ingebretson here, assistant for Sioux Valley.
You bet. Travis, you get to handle this halftime interview. That's a pretty intense first half of basketball.
Yeah, you know, and that's kind of what we expected. That's a good basketball team that we're playing, and we kind of knew that's what we're going to see. And just happy that we're playing well right now.
The coach wanted to get in the locker room right away. What do you think you guys are going to talk about?
I think we got to talk about adjustments in terms of just defensive, in terms of transition, and then also at the same time, just with their movement and stuff, and us kind of going back and forth on our defense and making adjustments.
How bad do the guys want to finish with a win today?
Yeah, you know, that's a big thing. You know, only four teams in Class A basketball get to finish with the win, and so that's huge, and both teams want it really bad. So it's been a fun first half. Looking forward to the second half.
All right, we'll see you in the second half.
Thank you.
More from Rapid City coming up.
As much as you have accomplished, there are times you'd rather not go it alone. While you determine what direction you go, we're here to help along the way. So go. Go with community. Go with neighbors. Go with understanding. Go with support.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy, so we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
What does primary care mean to us? At Sanford Health, it means being there when and where you need it most. It means building a relationship, because when a provider really knows you, they can deliver the best care for every aspect of your health and your life. So what does primary care mean for you? It means understanding your health for today and for where you're headed next. It means a lifetime of care for a lifetime of you.
Anthem Oats in Frederick is a proud community partner and supports high school activities in South Dakota. The Sumptions have been stewards of the soil since 1882. From the family farm right to your pantry. AnthemOats.com.
Are you nervous?
A little.
Bright things ahead, darling. Brightness and joy.
I've got plans.
Everything feels better after a cup of tea.
No talking.
I just want to be right here in this moment as you.
You're going to be a bigger star than ever.
This is good news for all of us.
Best episode ever.
And welcome back to Rapid City halftime of our Consolation Championship. Well, it's impossible to talk about inspiring people without talking about those who inspire our kids, these coaches. Ruth Dreamer took a job this season with the Ulrichs boys basketball team. Now, along with getting her feet wet in a new home, she's also helping lay the foundation of new traditions within the Tigers squad.
Basketball is life to me. I grew up watching it before I actually got to play the game. So I think that's where like the interest and the love for it grew, is I just got to be around it.
Ruth Dreamer has had a strong love for basketball her entire life. This year, she took a new job as the boys basketball coach for Ulrichs High School.
This number calls me and they're like, hey, are you coaching anywhere? And I'm like, no. And they're like, well, we need a coach. I'm like, where at? And they're like, Ulrichs boys varsity. I'm like, really? And they're like, yeah, if you're down. I'm like, yeah, sure, let me come in. You know, did the interview the next day, got hired. And it was definitely a challenge, because like I said, I didn't ever think I would. But it's exciting and it's fun. I really, really like it, especially with this group of boys. They're really eager to learn. So it's just been really, really an amazing experience.
Ruth grew up in Pine Ridge, where she became a standout player for the Lady Thorpes.
I actually had 1,800 points in my high school career. So the first thought people asked me was, well, when did I start playing in high school? And they actually asked me as a seventh grader to play, but I never wanted to. I always thought I was way too small. So I wanted to stay in middle school until I graduated eighth grade. But back then I played the first two quarters for my freshman team. So they're like, okay, we're gonna save you for JV. So then I played two quarters on JV. And they're like, okay, we're gonna save you for varsity. So I played two quarters on varsity. And then from that day on, I never played freshman or JV again. I became a starter for varsity for the rest of my career.
Ruth is focused on creating something special at her new home.
I guess it just shifted more or less to the program that I want to build here.
As long as you keep dribbling, he's going to get out of the way because you're bigger, but when you extend that arm, then it's offensive.
You know, and keep like Ulrichs is a great school. They have Wilding, they have Woods. We're actually getting a new weight room built. Like I said, this gym's only 2 years old, this whole school actually. So it's just exciting, because I think that's where like my mindset shifted, where I'm not like worried about my position as much as I am about like, what do you call it? Like the recreation of this school, like the foundation of it, you know? Like I really, really want to start and end my career here. Like this is the program I want to build.
It's a great opportunity. She pushes me to be the best that I can, and every day I practice. She doesn't force anything on me, and it just helps me love the game even more. You know, she just pushes me to be a better person every day, and I appreciate her for that. My first thought when I heard that a female coach was going to be our coach was I thought she wasn't going to be able to coach us because she's a girl and this is a man's sport. But after the first day of practice, she showed me that she has a lot more to offer than other coaches in the past year, and she knows a lot more than boys, you know, I could tell you that. She's a very vocal coach, but if you do something wrong, she ain't gonna get on your butt about it and tell you that you're doing something wrong. She's gonna teach you to stop doing that and make it a good habit rather than a bad habit. She taught me to eat right, healthy, treat your body just as, you know, you would. Don't put toxic things in it, like smoking, drinking, alcohol, and that stuff, you know.
Along with helping players be successful on and off the court, Ruth hopes she can also be a role model for future females in the state.
Honestly, I would say just, you know, stick with your goals and dreams. You know, like I said, I didn't think I'd be coaching a boys team, but I love it. It's exciting. It's a new challenge, and I'm always up for a new challenge. But, you know, just take your time and be patient, you know, because I almost was like I said, I was just going to sit back and not coach anywhere, you know, and I answered that call or whatever. But just, I would just say take your time and just stay focused, because you never know when your opportunity is going to present itself.
And we will be back of the second half in our Consolation Championship right after this.
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do, and that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
Oh my goodness.
We're trying to promote the Descendants of Doom tour, you know, trying to make everybody look kind of metal and, you know.
Menacing, menacing.
The band just got covered by Delta Dental, so they kind of can't stop smiling.
They need to look more metal, and they don't look metal. What do we do?
Pop off a few more, see what we get.
Give me some metal.
All right, yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Delta Dental!
We're all going somewhere. Going higher, faster, farther, going in new directions, to new places. At Monument Health, we keep going so you can keep going. We're dedicated to advanced orthopedic care with the latest innovations, technology, expertise, and treatment. So keep exploring, keep making memories, keep going with Monument Health as your partner. Learn more at monument.health/orthopedics.
Back in Rapid City, halftime. We're getting ready to start the third quarter with Sioux Valley and Pine Ridge. Stats from that first half. 56 shots going up in that first half.
Yeah, we had some good pace up and down the court. Neither team right now. Pine Ridge only 6 turnovers. Sioux Valley with 8, which is probably a couple more than you'd like, but yeah, we didn't have too many shot clock situations in that first half.
3-point shots made, rebounds, turnovers, all about the same. Just a couple of extra field goals from the floor. That's why Sioux Valley has this lead. Pine Ridge did outscore Sioux Valley in the second quarter, 12-11.
Yeah, Pine Ridge is probably feeling like they're going to need to get some damage done from the three against this group.
The quick turnaround by Ingebrigtsen. He has 9.
That was Mav Nelson, actually, with that finish. Up to 5 on the game for Mav.
Pine Ridge bringing Anthony Steele in to start this second half.
Number 14,
Nelson Cameron with the Nelson. Foul.
His first
at the line, Dominic Gosper. 79% free throw shooter. He is 1-for-2 in the tournament.
And Pine Ridge was really starting to figure some things out defensively there, especially in that middle portion of that second quarter. Had forced Sioux Valley to go over 3 minutes without scoring, and then cut the ball game to a one-possession game, and then the next thing you know, Sioux Valley scored on the last 3 of their offensive possessions in the first half and increased the lead back to what it was.
Hollowhorn on the bench to start the second quarter.
I think Coach Means probably likes how difficult they are to defend with 5 guards out on the floor.
Posting up, Ingebrigtsen to Squires. Count it. And 1.
Just such a tall task for Rulard. Ghost Bear right there. And Rulard tries to come help with the double team, but if he's able to get a catch,
6 feet away from the rim in the lane, just so strong and comfortable, taking a bounce either way, powering through for the finish, and there he completes the old-fashioned and one.
Oh, threw it behind Rouillard. Pine Ridge, seventh turnover.
Yeah, if this becomes just kind of a half-court game, and they're smart timeout by Bill Vincent, but this becomes more of a grinded-out half-court game where it's slower and having to run sets and run actions, that really favors the guy with the 6'10" guy, and that favors the Sioux Valley squad. And Pine Ridge needs to make this more of an up-and-down affair, a free-flowing affair with space, because that's when they're at their best.
Pine Ridge lost to Dakota Valley on Thursday. Pine Ridge beat Vermillion yesterday to get to the consolation championship.
And Coach Beans talked about it after that. They didn't feel like they gave Dakota Valley probably their best shot in that first day, but they bounced back in a big way with a resounding victory over Vermillion yesterday. And
Squires feeds it off to Rusink.
It's a heck of a sideline inbounds pass there from Christensen.
Steal, and it will stay with Pine Ridge. Only two losses on the season. They lost to Hot Springs early January, and then, of course, Thursday's loss.
There you see the impact that Squires makes defensively. Didn't block the shot, but altered Ghost Bears' attempt to come up a little short.
And that will go to Pine Ridge. It is Schiller back in for Sioux Valley. Sioux Valley only three losses on the year. The one on Thursday, and their other loss was to DeSmet and also to Hamlin during the regular season.
Yeah, I think the field that we've had here this week, I'm not sure you could really pick out a quote-unquote bad loss, and there's a nice find to steal for the finish. I don't think you could really pick out a quote-unquote bad loss or a game that a team should have won. Like, these teams took care of business in the regular season, and that's why they're here with us.
Foul on the Thorpes. On Xavier Little, that's his second. Here comes Hollowhorn in for Pine Ridge, and Rusing for Sioux Valley.
If you're Pine Ridge, Sioux Valley's trying to run all their sets, trying to run all their actions, you really just, you want to force them to take away different passes, just like Steele's doing right there. Yes, that's what it needs to be. It needs to be good ball pressure, and they're a quick timeout by Coach Means. But you don't want to allow them to just catch the ball right where they want to. They got a lot of stuff that starts with an elbow catch or a wing catch. You want to be able to try to force those catches out as much as you possibly can and try to make them as uncomfortable as you can. Because if they're able to just move the ball freely and run all their actions to get Squires deep touches, they're going to be tough to defend.
When we talked with Bill Vincent, the coach of Sioux Valley, on Wednesday, defensively, he says, we want to guard the paint. A little tougher to do that today with Pine Ridge, with their quickness, able to go into the paint, maybe kick it to the wing.
Yeah, they obviously they've shown a few different defensive looks, but you got to be keyed on to their ability to shoot the three, and that's probably something that they visited about in at halftime there. And right now, Pine Ridge 5 of 16 from three, and you can see them picking up the pressure.
Oh. Tough pressure by the Thorpes. Shot clock at 10. Squires traveled. Spin move on the travel. Timeout.
We all need insurance to protect our health, our homes, our belongings, and our businesses. But coverage is just the beginning. You also need the support of professionals who stand by your side to protect what's important to you. Fisher Rounds and Associates combines the coverage you want with the commitment you need. Fisher Rounds and Associates, at your service, at your side.
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
And welcome back, taking a look at the Pine Ridge bench. And one of Casey Means' assistant coaches is Charles Schrader Jr. He played high school ball at Pine Ridge, had a great career playing for Casey, and now he's joined the coaching ranks as well as being Casey's right-hand man. Charles and Casey are also cousins, and today is Charles Schrader Jr.'s birthday. Happy birthday. SDPB featured Charles's story back in 2020. Just search for Perseverance and the Charles Schrader Jr. story on SDPB.
How about that?
Yeah, I
birthday. Think it... What's a birthday gift today with a win? Richard the Third.
In and out. High quality look there for Richard the Third. And just so important on a coaching staff to have people that you can trust around you and loyal around you. And certainly when you get former players and close connections like that, they're just people that you always know are going to have your back. Helps out a lot as a head coach. And here they switch it. Pop Squires, they had success with this.
Stuck
there
with it.
There it is, yeah.
Rusink with eight.
Scored on that two different times yesterday.
Hollow horn. Richard the Third. And for Marvin, 14 points. Rusink. He had one of those yesterday. That's his first three in this game.
It's kind of a quick dagger. Wasn't much arc to that one, but
up travel.
Cossacks had a stretch there where they're up to 12 turnovers, and you can kind of feel Pine Ridge increase this pressure in the third quarter than what we were seeing in the first half.
Oh, that's a tough pass there, and it's gonna go to Pine Ridge.
Up to 13 turnovers with that one.
Ruliar, and he's got three threes in the game.
See Sioux Valley in their little
challenge to the rack. Rebound by Ghost Bear. And just because you get the rebound doesn't necessarily mean you're going to be keeping the ball with all the quick hands.
Foul number 11, Anthony Steele.
Steele with his first foul for Pine Ridge. As Little comes in, also Christian pulling him in.
Yeah, you got to be really tight. You collect those defensive rebounds. Pine Ridge going to be picking you up. 94 right on the catch.
Whoa, watch out. Oh. Stepped on the line.
Sioux Valley just getting a little bit more sped up than what you'd like to see. Back into the 1-3-1 alignment in the half court here.
Steele, his first three. 9 points. Oh, watched out. Rusink to Squires, and he missed the dunk. Foul will be on Hollowhorn. Watch out. Hollowhorn shaking up here a little bit. Hollowhorn limping up a little bit. Shake that off.
That's a lot of man coming barreling down at you.
Here's Squires. 1-for-3 from the line.
See, we got a high level of competitiveness out there right now. Both these teams.
Squires.
Foul that up with 12 rebounds at 3 consecutive. Here's O.
And that's out of bounds. Steele had the look, just missed shot.
Squires had 3 consecutive double-doubles in all 3 games of this state tournament. Going back to the same thing, just lob it, and then if they come with the trap, right back to Ingebretson.
Little guarding Ingebretson. That was blocked by Little. Jump ball called. Schiller was trying to call a timeout, but it's a jump ball.
Yeah, they didn't have it tied up for long, but
the officials getting a workout today.
Physical. Up and down. Not unexpected with these two groups.
Richard III going up against Squires, and Squires blocked it.
Nice verticality right there by Squires. Goes straight up off the floor.
Squires with the bucket. 16 for Squires. Little.
It's a good find. Need it. They've missed a few open ones here.
Schiller with the rebound. Oh. Hang on, Nate. Here we go. Both sides going up and down. Squires on the rebound. Squires with 13 rebounds to his 16 points.
Just feel like Pine Ridge is gonna need a few of those to drop in order to tighten this game up.
Squires with 16, Rusink with 11 to lead the way for Sioux Valley. For the Thorpes, Anthony Steele comes in. Sioux Valley has Hudson Rusin coming in.
Nelson.
Tosses it in as the inbounder right directly back to him, and he knocks it down from deep. Extends the lead to 14. Dorps are getting some good percentage looks and just not falling for him right now.
Final seconds of the third quarter. Nelson. Little. And Nelson with the foul.
They had, that's only their second team foul here in this third, so had some fouls to give and get their defense set here to try to finish this last 5.8 seconds.
Here comes Donovan Rose into the game. By the way, Donovan, his birthday today. Happy 18th birthday, Donovan Rose.
Happy birthday, Donovan. He wants to see a Cossacks win.
Rouillard is in for Pine Ridge. Richard the third. Schiller with the rebound. Through three. The Cossacks on top of the Thorps.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great. Like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
Bioethanol supplies more than just energy. It creates jobs in rural communities. It drives demand for local corn. It provides opportunities for family farms to thrive. To ensure agriculture plays a leading role in the efforts to decarbonize and transition energy, bioethanol remains at the forefront of a pursuit for a cleaner, brighter future for all Americans. Learn how at sdethanol.com.
And welcome back. Stacey Jones here. You're taking a look at Sioux Valley coach Bill Vincent. He's in his 27th year. He's ranked 14th all-time in wins in boys basketball, ranked number 5 in active coaches of all time. Heading into the tournament, or at the end of the regular season, I should say, at a record of 473 wins, 143 losses, and over 100 wins when he was the head coach of the girls basketball team in DeSmet and Sioux Valley as well, when girls basketball was played in the fall. So talked about Dusty. We got another legend in the making here with Bill Vincent.
And there's a family with him as well.
Yeah, great
coaching staff.
Great basketball family. Brother's an assistant. He's had one son, Tate, that played at Augustana. He's got another daughter that's playing for Dakota State. One yet in high school, Talia, that played for Coach Jamie Granum and the Sioux Valley girls, who had a successful season.
First team foul in the fourth quarter.
And he's got Travis Ingebrigtsen on staff as well, who used to coach at Brookings.
And of course, coaching his son, Maxwell, who's been a big part of this team.
A lot of connections, aren't there? Rouillard. Rebound by Rusink. Rusink with his sixth rebound.
You just see the attention that anytime 35 catches it.
And Squires is fouled. He'll go to the line. The pluses and minuses
of being a 6'10 player like Squires in high school. Gets a lot of attention from defenses, and offensively, just a great thing to have on in your back pocket.
Yeah, and you deal with some things that he's just not going to have to deal with when he's at South Dakota State. You just see some interesting defenses, and you know people are going to be trying to grab, clutch, and hold you 94 feet and send three or four guys at you. And you know this team. Well, there's a reason they're at the state tournament. He's blessed because he's got some good guard play as well. You know, there's times where you might have a pretty good big, but if you're not able to deliver him the ball where he needs, it can be fairly ineffective.
Been some tough shooting here for Pine Ridge, and a foul by Anthony Steele, and that's going to be two. That is a
I think Steele's been a little frustrated here over these last few minutes.
Intentional foul. So that intentional foul. Two free throws.
So they'll send Jace Christensen up there.
Jace is a 95% free throw shooter. 8 for 9 in the tournament.
Not a bad guy to send up there. That's what you want to see out of a guard and late game situations.
And they get the ball. Steele comes out. Dalen LeBeau reporting in for Pine Ridge.
And Pine Ridge has just went cold, especially from the three. There's a nice back screen action.
Blocked by Hollowhorn. But to finish, Squires. He's got 19.
An 8 of 9 from the floor. There's a reason when you shoot 70% on a season like Squires does.
Well, Squires picks up the foul, his second.
The third quarter is when it started to separate. It was Sioux Valley holding Pine Ridge to only 10 points and scoring 18, and now Pine Ridge has yet to score in the first 2 minutes of the fourth.
Ghost Bear on guarding Christofferson.
There, Hollowhorn does a nice job of fighting around to that three quarter to knock the ball out of bounds.
Foul on Ghost Bear. His first?
Third.
Third on Ghost Bear. I think Alex Squires has played all but about five seconds of the game. He went out for a quick break, but he's been in this whole game where everybody else has had a chance to take a break once in a while. That one was blocked.
Alex Squires.
The thing that you really got to appreciate from Alex Squires is, as a big guy, he's in good condition. And there, finally, Marvin Richard III. For a big guy, he plays with just such a high intensity and motor level, whether it's crashing the offensive glass, whether it's rim run and rim to rim in transition. It's really impressive for a big guy to play as much as he does at that level of intensity.
Casey Means inside the huddle, a guy that is fairly active along the sidelines throughout the game. guy with a lot of energy. You can see him in the background. He's always into the game, always out there supporting the players.
Showing his defensive stance there after the one defensive stop.
Dusty LeBeau is a big influence for Casey. You know, we had a shot of Dusty LeBeau earlier, the former great coach. Big influence on Casey. Mentor, an uncle, a father figure with Casey's dad passing away recently. And, you know, Dusty was always on discipline and togetherness. And Casey says he was taught from Dusty one heart, one mind, one fist. And it means a lot. Just a nice father figure that Casey has with Dusty LeBeau.
Yeah, and that's why you're going to see, regardless of whether this Thorpe's team is down 18 or if it's a two-point ball game, like they're going to be competing to the final horn and the final whistle. And this will be evidence of it here, this last 5-14, to see if the one thing about them, they can go on runs in a hurry. So we'll see if they can make one last push.
Ingebrigtsen. Media timeout.
Media timeout.
Just about halfway through the final quarter.
You're committed to building relationships, to exceeding expectations, to serving your community. Your financial partner should share your vision and your values. For 130 years, we've stood by South Dakotans. We've been there, we'll be there. Convenient, connected, committed. Bank West, member FDIC.
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do. And that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
And welcome back. This is definitely the place to be, Rapid City this weekend. Of course, we've got the State A basketball tournament going on right now inside the Summit Arena. Next door in the old Barnett Center, there's a youth basketball tournament. Then next to that in the Ice Arena, there's an AAU wrestling tournament, 1,700 kids for that. And then also in the auditorium, there's two orchestra shows, another 1,700 people for that. And I can speak for anybody who's been around here. Parking is a premium. A lot going on.
It is, as that is a turnover, but yeah, we've got thousands of people in this huge facility here, the old Rushmore Plaza Civic Center, which is, you know, connected to this new arena, the Monument. And they built the Ice Arena a few years back. That, of course, they've got Rush Hockey over there in Rapid City, and the auditorium where they have a lot of concerts, and then they have a convention hall as well. This is a huge facility, and it's a very busy facility today. Congrats to Rapid City. Three ball for Rouillard, his fourth of the game.
He found his favorite spot there over in the left corner, one of the favorite spots. And there it creates a turnover. See if they can turn it to offense.
Rebound by Little. Schiller with the steal, but he can't stay in bounds.
Schiller anticipated that pass. If Rouillard would have ended up going through, this might have been a 12-point game.
Hey,
after having the nice game yesterday, Royard backs it up, has 12. He's content to take a little time off the clock.
Timeout.
Timeout, Sioux Valley.
By Sioux Valley. I'm just looking at the, how many, what's the record for most three-point shots made in a Class A tournament? Most three-point shots made in a Class A tournament. That'd be for three games. Yesterday we talked about for one game, it's nine by Travis Traphagen of Groton back in 1995.
This is just by an individual, you're saying?
Yes.
In the three-game tournament?
Yes, because Jalen Roulard has 14 trays in this tournament.
What is the record?
18.
18. By who?
Josh Mueller.
Josh Mueller.
Central, 2001.
He could shoot it a little bit, huh?
There are a lot of individual scoring records that are 24, 25 years old.
Yeah, and if you would have told Josh that he needed to hit 20 in the three games, he would have got that done for you as well.
He probably would have.
Come out here in a little 1-2-1 or 1-2-2 extended half-court zone. Shot clock's under 10.
Trouble underneath. And Rusink.
Rusink with the soft touch there. Sometimes those 10, 12 footers on the baseline aren't the easiest shots.
And it's gonna go to Sioux Valley. Thorpe's gonna get ready to bring in extra players. Looks like they're going to bring the bench out as Kenny Pulliam reporting in. Daniel Weston, Michael Cawley. There goes Rulliard out, getting a big hug from Casey Means. Xavier Little coming out. Kanye Hollowhorn coming out, getting big hugs from the coach, getting emotional on the sideline.
Yeah, all three of those guys are seniors for the Thorpes. And Little and Rulliard and Hollowhorn, and were such big parts of the type of season that they had.
And a jump ball. Let's see, also in there, let's see, we told you Kenny Pulliam was out there. Sioux Valley bringing out Tobin Squires. And here comes Alex Squires, the senior, coming out. A big tournament. The senior leaving the game with 21 points.
Yeah, heck of a career for the big fella who's set some all-time records for Sioux Valley and rebounds and dunks and field goal percentage.
Wild on the floor. To the wing, Jace Christensen for three. That's his third. And we got a timeout. Coming in for the Thorpes will be Anthony Little. Is coming out for Sioux Valley is Christensen.
Christensen for Sioux Valley.
And for the Thorpes, here comes Marvin Richard III. He's coming out. Dominic Ghostbear.
And sub from Max Engelbrechtsen.
Well, Coach Means going to see those two guys again next year.
Yeah, probably visiting with them about how proud and the type of offseason that they're going to need to have. And Sioux Valley doing the same, checking Maxwell Ingebretson and Rusink.
Here comes Rusink out, the senior. For Sioux Valley, McCade Nelson is in. Maverick Nelson, Tobin Squires, Bowden Schiller.
Yeah, it's fun to see. You had a couple seniors, and there's a steal by Brock Christofferson. You had a couple seniors in Jace Christensen and Hudson Rusick that are really role guys for them, and both end up in their last high school game scoring in double figures. Rusick with 13 and Christensen with 13, and they were big, big boons when Maxwell Ingebretson had a little bit more quiet of a night, 3 of 10, only 7 for him.
Here comes Schiller. Bowden Schiller, a senior, getting a hug from Coach Vincent. In the ball game, Donovan Rose for Sioux Valley. It's his birthday today. Maverick Nelson. And Maverick is going to go to the line.
Foul number 34, Daniel Weston.
Foul on Daniel Weston. His first.
Maverick Nelson.
Maverick is 6'2 junior. In for the Thorpes. Coming in is Tokea Big Crow. He had 2 threes in the game yesterday. Dalen LeBeau. And Christian Pulliam. Coach Means counting out there to see if he has enough on the floor.
Had a lot of substitutions here in a short period of time.
Tobin Squires able to get it. Stolen by Kenny Pulliam along the wing. Squires with the rebound and can't hold on to it. In for Sioux Valley, Brett Milton. Here comes Maverick Nelson out of the game. Christian Pulliam. Rebound is by Kenny Pulliam. Shot by Michael Pauley is blocked. By Rose. And Rose coming out. Everybody trying to get some playing time today.
Yeah, utilized in the last couple minutes. As a coach, you always want, regardless of who you got in the game, you want to operate at a level that you can be proud of.
Brady Hiltonen for Sioux Valley coming in. Carter Sapp coming in. Christian Pulliam will bring it over. The longest.
Dalen LeBeau.
With the big smile on his face after knocking that down.
I like it. Shoot away.
Yeah, I have a feeling we might be seeing a couple of these guys potentially on the all-tournament team with the type of games that they had here this weekend for us, with potentially Marvin Richard III and Alex Squires. They'd have my votes, Craig. They don't ask me. I don't get a vote. But
I think you got some pretty good names there.
I'm giving my endorsement right now.
Donovan Rose back in for Sioux Valley. Brett Milton, down low to Sapp, and Sapp hit the basket.
They've gotten a bunch of those deep catches and deep touches.
This is Tokea Big Crow. And a foul. Going to be on Rose. And Christian Pulliam is going to go to the line.
Number 10, Donovan Rose, first 13 foul. Two shots for Christian Pulliam.
Pulliam, 6'2 sophomore. In for Sioux Valley, McCade Nelson. Coming out, Carter Sapp. The award ceremony will be coming up right after this ball game. As a timeout will be taken by Sioux Valley. Let's look at the seniors from both clubs. Certainly for Pine Ridge, we got Xavier Little, Jalen Roulard, Kanye Hollowhorn, and Caden Steele. Those four seniors for Pine Ridge. For Sioux Valley, Bowden Schiller, Max Ingebrigtsen, Jace Christensen, Hudson Rusink, and Alex Squires.
This was really the type of game in order for Sioux Valley to have success. This is how you'd want it. Holding Pine Ridge to right around 50 points, potentially 51 here.
On the board for Pulliam. And the steal and the quick shot almost by Daylon LeBeau. There's your final, 69-51. Sioux Valley with the win, and they are the consolation champions. And for Sioux Valley, it is the fifth time in their history that they have been consolation champions. Sioux Valley, they were consolation champs a year ago. So 2 years in a row finishing as the consolation champs.
Yeah, found a way to bounce back after getting beat in that opening round game in a tough double overtime thriller against Rapid City Christian, and have played two very complete basketball games, taking care of Groton area and then Pine Ridge here tonight, and being both efficient offensively and tough defensively.
Casey Means and Bill Vincent.
It's a lot of respect, and talking with Coach Vincent, these two teams are really active in their summer programs and the tournaments
Ladies
that they're playing.
We would like to present the awards. The teams have played for the Consolation Championship, fifth and sixth places. To present the awards are Danny Walking Eagle, Marty Weissmantle, Eric Denning, and Kelly Mesmer from the South Dakota High School Activities Association Board of Directors. Assisting with the team awards presentation are representatives from the Activity Association's corporate partners, Tom Weaver from Dakota Bank, and Staff Sergeant Kyle Griffith from the South Dakota Army National Guard. The sixth place team in Class A, the Pine Ridge Thorps. Players are Xavier Little, Marvin Richard III, Christian Pulliam, Dominic Ghostbear, Anthony Little, Daylon LeBeau, Michael Kale, Anthony Steele, Jalen Rulliard, Takea Big Crow, LaDanian Crazy Thunder, Kanye Hollowhorn, Kenny Pulliam, Daniel Weston, and Caden Steele. Ball boys are Parker Brewer and Kingston Pedregon. Assistant coaches, happy birthday to Charles Schrader Jr., Will Goodeagle, and Mike Brave. Accepting the sixth place trophy in Class A, the head coach for the Pine Ridge Thorpes, Casey Means. Congratulations. A welcome home celebration will be held for Pine Ridge. We'll meet at Four Away, the Pine Ridge High School Dining Hall at 2:30 tomorrow afternoon. The fifth place team, the consolation champions in Class A, the Sioux Valley Cossacks. Players are Brady Hiltonen, Braden Dan Zeeson, Bowden Schiller, Brett Milton, Maxwell Engebretson, Jace Christensen. Happy birthday, Donovan Rose. Maverick Nelson. Tobin Squires. Brock Christofferson. McCabe Nelson. Carter Sapp. Hudson Rusink. And Alex Squires. Ball boys are Parker Top, Tostin Tangen, Braden Plummer, Ryder Ford. Statistician is Elizabeth Deckenicker. Manager Ann Vostad. Assistant coaches Noah Clare, Nick Geffrey, Buster Vincent, Colin Vanderwall, David Carman, Travis Ingebretson. Accepting the fifth place trophy, the consolation championship trophy, the head coach for the Sioux Valley Cossacks, Bill Vincent. A welcome home celebration will be held for Sioux Valley at the Cossack Center tomorrow afternoon at 4 p.m. Congratulations to both teams.
And we've got more to come from Rapid City.
You live life on the move. While you determine what direction that may be, we're here to help along the way. So go. Go with values. Go with friends. Go with support. Go with convenience.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association.
We're focused on policy, so we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Lucky for us, life is full of choices, big and small, just as it should be. They define us, make us who we are. And when it comes time for you to choose, a car, home, your next big adventure, or start a new business, Farmers Union Insurance has the variety of choices to make sure you have the perfect coverage to protect each perfect moment. Farmers Union Insurance.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
You never have any. The pictures have been taken of the consolation champs as Sioux Valley gets the win here this afternoon. 69-51 over Pine Ridge. There's a good-looking shot of the Cossacks. And the second half, shooting continued from the outside for Sioux Valley. They got a couple of threes, but really it was an inside game. A lot for Sioux Valley.
Yeah, Alex Squires, 9 of 10 from the floor, finished with 21 points, 17 rebounds, 5 of them offensively. Just an impressive display from the big guy.
For Pine Ridge, Marvin Richard III and Jalen Roulard hitting from the outside. You know, the well kind of went dry. The spigot kind of closed up on the shots for Pine Ridge.
It did in the second half. And Sioux Valley made some adjustments defensively, but made it tough on them. The Thorps only finished the game 18 of 58, 31% overall, 9 of 33 from three, and just couldn't quite find enough offense.
We'll wrap things up when we come back.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great, like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
Our teams are committed to improving quality of life in our communities. Whether we're planning construction concepts, building a new downtown development, bringing new businesses to our communities, or maintaining your apartment home. We believe everyone deserves a well-built and well-managed place to live and work. This is Lloyd.
Oh my goodness.
I decided to switch my major. I didn't want to do sports anymore, so I decided Southeast Tech would be a good one for me to go. The current instructor is a captain with the Highway Patrol. He had a lot of experience and knowledge about the job. I serve the people just as much as they serve me.
The way humans make sense of the world is through stories.
We've got to go ahead and start training to go to Mars.
And lift off.
We pay tribute to all who serve and who have served.
Civilization is precious. Life is precious.
Artists here are making a difference.
I'm trying to seek redemption.
And
And welcome back to the Summit Arena inside the Monument in Rapid City, where we're having the Class A State Boys Basketball Tournament. Had our consolation games this afternoon. A lot of fun basketball this afternoon and a great night still to come. Let's take a look at what happened earlier today. For 7th and 8th place, Groton area defeating Vermillion 67-49. And then in our consolation championship, it was Sioux Valley defeating Pine Ridge 69-51. And now we're all set as well to get ready for our championship and our 3rd and 4th place game coming up tonight. We'll be back on the air at 6 o'clock Mountain Time tonight, where we will see Rapid City Christian face off against Dakota Valley for our 3rd place and then our championship. That will follow that game between Sioux Falls Christian, undefeated Sioux Falls Christian, and Hamlin. That is all coming up tonight. Do not miss it. We will be back here on SDPB. I'm Stacey Jones for Craig Maddock and Nate Kading. We'll see you in a little bit.